Renew it! Do it over!
Wow, Blaine is fired up.
Man,
Blaine,
you're really taking Gus's spot.
I'm in the Gus chair.
All right, everybody calm down.
Are we redoing it or not?
Listen, should we have a chill one? What does that mean?
I get it.
Oh, I get you. That's good. You're good with the segues.
New shirt.
Gavin is wearing our new shirt, Podcast and Chill.
I was wearing my Laser Team one, but I took it off to swap it with this one.
We don't get podcast shirts all that often.
We don't.
We get them occasionally.
I'm on one of them, and it was one of the proudest moments of my journey.
You're on a shirt?
Before we get into shirts.
It says superhuman.
I have something I want to say.
Wait, you pin in that thought, Barbara?
I'm pinning it.
You will have first right. You'll have the floor first. Why don't you introduce yourselves for people who are listening at home.
Hi, I'm Blaine.
I'm Gavin.
I'm Barbara.
And I'm Bernie.
And I'm Blaine.
Stop it. All right. It's not even funny.
He's allowed to do it.
What is your thing?
Wait,
like
who are we sponsored by? That
shush. Oh, we're sponsored by
You shush
Blue
me, and then
Apron
you go
and Squarespace. They've made all this possible.
Wow.
Keeping the wheels turning, get shushed.
So two great sponsors.
I have a feeling we'll be talking about them later in the program.
Perhaps.
We'll be talking about.
Why
these
do you sound like
fine
Todd.
Merchants? What?
Because he is.
I have to pull Gus's job today.
You're coming through like feedback.
So are you?
Oh, ooh. There's always one person every podcast who has the God mic that you can hear them on all the speakers. Do I have it this
it's
time?
It's never Barbara.
It's never me. I mean, I don't talk this close to my mic.
It's
if
all
I do,
of us.
Then it happens.
All right, Barbara, what's your story? Let's take the pin out.
So I want to start off the podcast before we get into everything to say that today is a very, very special day. You know, we're all here on the podcast together.
Why did it cut to Bernie?
Today is the birthday of a very special man who we all admire and love and cherish very greatly.
Sounds like a great guy.
That is Mr. Chris Damaris.
Wow.
So happy birthday, Chris.
Happy birthday, Chris.
Happy birthday, Chris.
Yes.
How old is Chris?
I think he's 29.
I would say 28.
Or 28.
I feel like you pulled a switcheroo on that one.
Also, it is Bernie Burns' birthday.
Hey.
Happy birthday, Bernie Burns.
You know, someone was saying, do you want us to say happy birthday to you at the Monday meeting? And I was like, there's like 150 people. What was that?
There's been four balloons.
We have some party hats.
Oh, this one's going to hit you right on the head. Oh, I missed.
Blaine, what color would you like?
Green or
happy
purple,
birthday,
please.
I want
There's
blue.
No purple.
I want blue.
Green, please.
So I encouraged... get a green for Achievement Hunter.
Can you give me the other green one, too?
I'll take a red.
Yeah,
I'll take a blue one.
Switch.
I want blue.
I'm a blue team.
Green sucks.
You get what you want.
Can I get a green team? Or another green? Double up.
You got really excited when you saw something that was Achievement Hunter colors. Oh, it was our...
Plane
that we did in our simple planes.
You know what I say to that?
Oh, those are gonna get old fast.
Happy birthday!
Just
happy
like me on my birthday, get old fast.
Hey, give me the rest of them.
And you're 21 now?
No, the hat.
Today, Gavin, this is my 43rd
Keep
birthday.
Going.
It is not.
It is 43. I'm 43 years old. What do you think about that? How old are you?
27.
27. Seems like you're catching up.
Yeah.
Somehow or some way.
That's
I the
still
way
remember that time
though.
When you were 32 and I was 16.
Here, I'll do this.
There you go. How old were you when you started Red vs. Blue?
Oh, look at that. 10 years.
Look at that young man.
Now you're a teenager.
Backwards cap, does it? I look like Barb now. How old was I, what?
When you started Red vs. Blue.
Man, I guess...
27?
I think... No. I was like right at the end of my 20s. I was 29. Dear Lord. Look at Blaine down there. And actually, I think about that too.
I did not see you doing that.
I think about that because people always talk to us like, how can I get started or whatever. Usually people have that conversation.
Can
around,
you
like,
do the whole thing?
17
like
or 18?
Yeah.
And the conversation is like, if we start talking to them and say like, well, you get going on stuff and build up a portfolio and all that. And you can see the light just go out in their eyes.
Yeah.
They just
want to
know like, what button do I press to become world famous on YouTube? You know, that's because that's the environment now today is they feel like they can do that. And, it's like when you talk about building a portfolio and stuff like that, it's like, but you could do it like for 2 or 3 years. And even if you started now, like if you're 15, you started now, you'd be so far ahead of 3 years of experience, you know, in some kind of art form. By the time you're 18, you'll be so far ahead of everybody else. And they're just like, I don't know what to do with that. We were at it for like 11 years before it got to be a point. Oh, look at this.
We went all out.
Holy cow. You guys went all out.
Happy birthday.
All right, walk slower. You're going to blow the candles out.
We can't sing it. Because
nailed it.
It says congratulations. It says I don't know if we want to get a camera on that.
The G is melting. Gavin, how much did you pay me to do the whole podcast?
Thank you.
On your birth?
10,000 things I want to do with that cake. If you guys had brought it out at the end of this podcast, this would go entirely differently. That cake,
you just
that cake would be like
ahead.
On Gavin. All right, you ready for me to blow these out?
Make a wish.
The pussiest blow.
With Barb. I don't know why. It's like one running joke I have with Barb. Hey, thank you, everybody. I have a running joke with Barbara where if Barbara's in the room and I have a piece of paper and I'll crumple up the paper and I'll look at the garbage can and I'll size up and then I just go and I like let it fall out of my hand to the ground. She always falls for it every single time. I can size it up for like a minute. I'll sit there
nothing
and look.
Nothing gets old for Barbara. The same crap. Since the day I met you, you laugh at it still to this day.
Thank you very much.
Oh, is that a spatula?
There's something very funny to me.
Thank you, Mariel.
That's your gift, Gavin.
Look how well prepared we are for this.
Isn't Pancake Day coming?
All right, who wants cake?
It is.
When is that?
Plates here. Any crew want cake?
Do you want some help? You have a busted up finger that I'm sure we'll talk about in a little bit.
We want to tell that story? Is this your thing that you put a pin in, Barbara? Was this a discussion of...
Yeah,
older?
It was absolutely about your birthday.
Right, we needed a pin for that?
Yeah. Hold it.
I just wanted to
hold
make sure
it. Hold. There, thank you. Oh, the cake's going.
Save it, Blaine.
Good grief.
There's a lot of jokes that Bernie makes that I laugh at.
I flipped it over. Here, that's yours.
Blaine, how much to eat that in one mouthful?
This?
Yeah.
How much are you going to give me?
50 quid. 50 bucks.
50 in bucks, dude.
How do you mean by that? So, like, I have to stuff it in and
like,
then...
everything that's on the plate has to be in your mouth
no, I'm good. At one point the same in time, time. I don't think that's even going to be possible.
You could try, though.
You want a slice?
No, I'm good.
For $50?
So, does that mean I'm the last one?
Can you give me a spoon, Bernie?
Yeah, tell yours. Oh, yeah, buddy.
Just throw it here.
I can't throw so well with my middle
finger. Oh, eating off the spatula. That's classic.
Nobody else wanted any.
Okay, I'm so $50. Okay.
Yeah, size it
I don't think it's possible.
No, you can compress that. There's a lot of air in a cake.
I don't know. That's a pretty dense
can
cake.
Can I cheat? Can I, like, put it in my hands and mush it?
Yeah.
That's a pretty dense cake.
But you only get the money if you actually do it.
I remember for Barb's birthday,
can't get a trash
one
can.
Year, we made a we dick cake. Oh, do we ever talk about that?
Ashley and Aaron Zek, right?
Yeah.
Wasn't it completely inedible as well?
Yeah.
It looked like a dick would, like, if dick was a cake,
yeah.
It looked like that would
oh my God, look at Blaine down there.
Shoveling it.
So Blaine is trying to fit an entire piece of a massive corner of a cake.
We should get a disgusting zoom in on this.
It's like that scene from Matilda.
What's the Matilda? What's the scene from Matilda?
Bruce.
Somebody
Bruce,
choked
Bruce,
to death on
Bruce.
Cake.
Yeah. Pam Ferris going nuts.
She makes the kid eat
he's
the
so
cake.
He's so fucking happy.
That's going to be the thumbnail.
You can't eat the cake.
Don't die. Don't choke to death. He sounds muted. Say anything at all. It sounds like he's muted. It's like behind like a wall of lead. He did it. That's $50.
No, there's still some there.
Yeah. Here, do you want to swallow some before you?
No, he can't do that.
Oh, he can't.
Now he can swallow. Oh, you're killing me.
It's coming out. He's put it in and like it's coming out.
If you guys are listening to the audio version of the podcast, it's basically it looks like the first 5 minutes of 2001. It's like. He's got this simian look on his face, and he's jamming food into his mouth. Look at him. You look like a... You... Okay, that's good.
I'll
you're done.
Well done. That's 50 bucks.
Good job.
50 bucks. Did you get the swallow? Oh, God. Blaine! Did he have to swallow it?
No, you don't have to swallow
it. I heard him bubble up. I'm sorry.
You're not sorry.
I laughed so hard that I farted. Can I get a trash can?
In case you didn't hear that, Blaine said,
I
laughed
trash
so hard
can. How about there's a paper bag right there?
That'd be great. I can't reach because my hands are so dirty. Can somebody give me wet wipies, little wipey towels?
That's a big assumption. Here you got some dry towels coming in. That's going to help. Grab it with your hands.
Be my hands.
We're not touching you. Nobody is touching you.
Just be my hands.
I got you.
Oh, look this way.
It's really not that bad,
Gavin. It's such a good way. Here. I heard it bubbling and like goggling.
Yeah, but it's just cake.
It's Martin Luther King Day, by the way, as well. My birthday always falls on Martin Luther King Day.
That's how I normally celebrate.
Always? Or just once
no,
every 7
well,
years.
You know, it's whatever. So, I noticed that because there's a major holiday, it's a Monday.
Yeah.
I noticed that my birthday kind of gravitates towards Monday and away from Monday. But are there certain days of the week that dates never fall on? Like, will January 18th
always fall on either like a Thursday, a Saturday, or a Monday.
You're a lunatic.
Or does it make it through every day of the week?
No, it goes the next day, and then leap year, it skips a day, and then it'll do the next four years.
No, I don't think that's the way that works.
Yeah, it is.
I don't think that's the way it works. Okay, so what you're saying for sure
tomorrow
is that January 18th, my birthday,
next
2015
year.
Was what? Was a Sunday?
No, it would have been a Saturday because today's a leap year. This year's a leap year.
This year's a leap year. So
wait, but it hasn't been Feb yet, so it would have been Sunday.
It would have been a Sunday.
Okay.
Check it on your calendar.
What day was January? I can probably just get my calendar out. 2015. Oops.
You could just open your calendar.
I could do that.
Don't need wipey towels.
Go back a year.
Wet towels.
Just keep saying wipey.
It was a Sunday.
Yeah.
And now it's a Monday. So you're saying 2014 would have been
Saturday.
A Saturday.
And the next year it'll be a.
You're correct.
How Wednesday? Do you not know how the years and days work?
Well, this is a very specific thing about the years and the dates, like that they go one day at a time. They advance. I never knew that. If that's a thing that everybody else knows but me, I did not know that.
Did you guys know?
Yeah, I knew.
They just advance one day.
Yeah.
Huh.
Like how Christmas last year was. Well, the year before was a Thursday, and this year was a Friday?
In 2013, my birthday was on a Friday.
The reason I know that is because my birthday's in the summer, so I would always try to see if my birthday fell on a weekend, so I could plan, like, a birthday party.
Yeah. Mm. You have cake all over your face.
Do I?
Yeah, so 2010 would have been the last year that my birthday fell on Martin Luther King Day.
Yeah, Barbara, you look stupid.
Who else do I share a birthday with besides Chris Demers? Muhammad Ali. There's no reason why you'd know that. I wouldn't be surprised. We have so many people at the company now. I wouldn't be surprised if there's a third person who has this is their birthday.
Come forward.
Probably.
So you just every year would just think, oh, luck of the draw, what day of the week it's going to be.
I just didn't notice. I mean, seriously.
Oh.
The closest thing, I wouldn't notice for my own birthday.
And last year was Monday. Damn it.
So I wouldn't notice, chances. Except for the fact that Martin Luther King Day falls around the same time. I would notice, though, that, like, December 25th and January 1st are exactly 7 days apart. So those always fall on the same day of the week every year relative to one another. Mm-hmm. But I never noticed before that they advance through all the days. I'm honest, if people know that, that's, like, a fact that people have learned. I never have noticed that trend. Control room, am I alone in this? Did you guys know that that's the case?
No.
That days advance? No.
I thought that was common knowledge.
Is it, like, they don't teach Americans that?
That the days advance through the explain it to me. Like, how does that explained in education? Explain it to me.
I have no idea. It's just like a fact that I know.
Like, just explain it like someone's never heard that fact before. How do they teach it to you?
Like, I never got taught. I just like,
yeah.
Because
you just
being alive 27 years,
well,
I've noticed
just,
a pattern.
You just asked, they don't teach that in America. We have calendars in America, you know? So it's like, it's a fact you pick up, but it's not something that somebody sits down and ever teaches you.
I don't think anyone ever taught me, no.
I wonder if people can. There's going to be some people who don't understand what the fuck we're talking about.
You base knowledge on your own experience.
Yes, I'm just saying. That would mean my memory has to go back not only 1 year, but 2 years to make like a trend. Not happening. I mean,
no,
I
you don't need one. You need 1 year. You need 1 year ago from today to figure that out.
But a leap year actually keeps it consistent to where even across a leap year, it doesn't move up a day or anything.
It does.
I just went back 6 years. I went across a leap year in 2012, and it didn't change.
So what's it going to be next year for you? Is it going to be a Wednesday or a Tuesday?
Well, next year will be Wednesday, because this year's a leap year.
What?
Well, if he's saying leap years don't change it.
Leap years do change it.
That's why people don't know this, because it's like there's a caveat.
Yeah, leap years change it.
So it's going to be Wednesday.
He's absolutely right.
Wednesday. But
by a day?
Honestly, most people this year have skipped a day, but because you're one of the few whose birthday is before the leap day. Then
I'm
you
like
don't
the
experience
kid.
That this year.
How do they handle the age stuff in UK schools? Like, do they
every
have
year someone
days?
Goes up by 1 year,
but on a different day of the week? No, like what's the cutoff day for the UK for you go to kindergarten? Is kindergarten your first official level of school?
No, because it's German.
Okay, what is your first level of school?
Reception.
Reception. Okay, when someone goes to start reception,
like you're
what is
the reception
how old do you have to be to go to reception?
How old?
Yes.
Four.
I think it's four.
Okay. So, like, what's the cutoff date for that? Like, the
I think it's, like, very early September.
Very
it's
early
like
September?
The oldest kids are born on the early days of September.
Right. Okay. Yeah, that's, Teddy's like that. Teddy's, like, one of the oldest kids in his class.
Wait, how do they do it with us? I got held back.
What grade did you get held back in?
Did you really?
Yeah. Well, it wasn't because it was, like, dumb or anything. don't think.
That's what they said.
No, it was because my mom was a teacher, and they knew that I was going to... My dad was a late bloomer, and they knew that, they wanted me to play football. B, since I'm a May birthday, I was going to be either extremely young or extremely old for my class. So they're like, let's just opt for him being older and possibly more grown when he plays football in the future.
You mean younger?
But why not start you later?
Older.
Why not start you later? What grade would you held back?
Oh, because I think it actually helped out because I was like, I was pretty smart, you know? So, like, going through kindergarten twice was like, you know, color within the lines a little bit better the next time.
No, it's true.
Yeah, like and that's all the fun stuff anyway.
Yeah, would you rather be the smartest guy or the oldest guy in a young class or the youngest person in an older
oldest
class?
Oldest is, but yeah, easy. Yeah.
Rather than being pushed ahead.
I was like 19 or 20 when I graduated. No.
You were probably 19 then when you graduated.
Yeah. I just remember people being like,
I graduated at 17. Old. It was the exact opposite. And I was a very late bloomer, so I didn't like hit puberty until I was a junior in high school.
How do you think that affected you socially?
I dated more in middle school.
Okay.
Like 6th to 8th grade.
Playa.
Than I did my first 2 years in high school. Like, I was much, much more, I don't know, successful dater. I don't know, we didn't have Tinder back then. I don't know, is it? But I was way like smaller than everybody else. Mm. But I think that, you know, that kind of thing like made me focus way more on school and stuff like that. But my junior and senior, I, you know, caught up on dating. I grew like 6 inches in 8 months.
Ouch.
So, yeah.
You must have had terrible growing pains.
It was painful. It was very painful.
It's painful.
Did
for
you have stretch marks?
I never got stretch marks. I don't understand how those work. Are stretch marks like when you grow too fast or gain too much weight and then your skin stretches, or is it like, it seems like for people who lose a lot of weight have stretch marks.
It happens in both cases.
It happens. Well, how do you get a stretch mark by losing weight? That doesn't make sense to me. Or does it just reveal when the skin comes back?
Yeah.
That's where the thing was. Like,
I don't know if stretch mark is the right word for it.
I was going to talk about testicles. I wonder if that has anything to do with
testicles.
You know how testicles
are. What grade were you held back in?
What's that?
What grade were you held back in?
Kindergarten.
You were held back in kindergarten.
Yeah.
So hot.
Oh, did you go to kindergarten twice?
Yes.
That's kind of
Miss Elliott and Miss Stroop.
That is kind of just like starting later, though. That's all it is.
Yeah. He's nice. He's cool.
Yeah, I actually skip reception.
I went straight to what?
Level one?
I just went straight into year one.
Year one. The way you guys number your school stuff is awful.
Yeah, and then they call everything
uni. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Whatever. But then you have your A levels and your...
That's just the exams you take.
What's the thing that's after A levels that you do, though?
That's you going to university.
When do you take your owls?
Well, you have like a college too, though, right? Don't you have like a college thing too?
There's colleges, yeah. They're separate to universities typically.
So are college and university the same level?
Yeah. Well, it's usually, you can leave school at 16. You can do your GCSEs. They determine like what A levels you take. Or you can not do that and just go to college and.
So wait a minute.
Do specifics.
So if you take your GCSE?
GCSEs, yeah.
GCSE?
Used to be called O levels.
Okay. And that determines what A level test you're going to take.
No, so it tells it, like, then you pick. So say I want to do A level science. I need to get at least a C in my science GCSE.
It's just a test and you take another test? Or do you go to more school and then take a test?
Well, no, they're qualifications. So like, you can go to a job and say I've got a C, a GCSE in English.
Okay.
Isn't that something else that you guys do different too? Is like grades?
It's not confusing me. You try to explain it.
Here's why America
confused.
Is weird, right?
Go on.
When you're like 18 and you're like trying to finish up school, you still have to do all the crap, like maths, even if you're not doing that. But in A levels, you're only doing you're not doing all the fodder that comes with other lessons. You're just doing like the three subjects that you want to do.
So are A levels grades or are they tests?
They're qualifications.
Okay, so do you understand why this is confusing?
For example, I have 9...
You said, it's just numbers. That's how you started this conversation.
No, that's
it's
the
just numbers.
I have 9.5 GCSEs and 3 A-levels.
I don't understand what
my qualifications.
This makes zero sense.
I don't
sense.
Have a degree.
Spouting numbers and
so
then words.
You got to 10
numbers.
Year 10, and then somebody threw a lot of letters at you. That's exactly
no,
what
no,
you
no,
said
you
to
take
me.
Your GCSEs at the end of year 11.
Year 11?
Is that a test?
You take a GCSE. So yeah. End of your 11th year, you take your GCSE. And then you're done...
And then that's age 16, you can go and like, you know, a lot of my friends like became a plumber at that point.
Oh,
or
good for them.
You do years 12 and 13, and that's called the sixth form.
Do you get this
and
now?
Then you do
do
your
you understand?
And then
it
you
was
do
so
your
simple
AS
when
levels.
You started, Barbara.
Bernie.
Now there's another school after school.
I think he's making this up.
No, sixth form's the thing.
Sixth form is
and
just
that's not university.
It's years 12 and 13, no.
Sixth form?
So that's like our senior year?
Form.
And
right?
A 13th
sixth
year.
Sixth form.
And then you do your AS levels and then your A2s. They're known as your A levels.
Well, okay, granted.
Why
we
is it
do...
called sixth form in 11th grade?
Well, so Bernie, we do kindergarten, then first, second, third, fourth, fifth, and then up to 12.
Yeah, I want somebody to make an edit of Gavin talking to me. What do you mean it's complicated? It's just numbered for the years. Then immediately cut to him going, A levels, GSE. Sixth form, college,
plumber,
O level, plumber,
reception.
But all your stuff has like dumb names, like junior, and then like
freshman, sophomore, junior,
blood.
Senior.
But we literally have 11. Just
like
numbers for the year.
Juniors.
You go grade it's one a, through 12, and then that's it.
Yeah.
Then you go to university if you want to, or you don't.
Yeah,
that's it.
That's like
just,
me saying.
I explained that in 5 seconds.
Okay. Well, let me do it in 5 seconds. You do years 1 through 13, and then you go to university if you want. And if you want to do 12 and 13.
So do you have to do 3 years of university then, since you did 13 years of high school?
Yeah, the degree of 3 or 4 years.
I could also explain that somebody could drop out and get their GED, which is their high school equivalency, but that's an alternative to the American school system.
That's so basically if we dropped out. And
listen, I don't want to get on Twitter and hear everybody in the fucking UK telling me how smart Gavin is and how he just doesn't explain things well. Your system's fucked up and you should be
ashamed. So can you leave school at 16?
Sure.
Yeah,
you can leave school at eighth grade.
Yeah, but that's,
you don't have to go to school.
Oh, really?
It's
the law.
Homeschooled kids, they just take them out of school. Homeschooled, they can just run the kids through the yard.
It's a law in Canada to stay till 16th.
Yeah, that's why, like, at the beginning of your A-levels, they're like, all right, you don't have to be here anymore. So if you're not going to do work, then piss off. Not interested in teaching someone who's not.
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah.
That's when kids get rowdy, is like 11th and 12th grade.
And so that's A-levels.
Yeah.
And don't you sometimes take A-levels? 12, you say A-levels, that's a test. Then you take sixth form after A-levels, and sixth form is also called college.
I can't help you. I can't help
you. How do you guys grade? Do you have like A's, B's, C's?
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then
it's a wonder anybody ever gets out of that fucking school system over there.
Not A plus?
No, not A plus.
Do you have a B star and C star?
No. D minus. You can also get a U.
What's you?
I'm almost afraid to look at Twitter.
It means
I have 550 unread tweets that are directed at RT Podcast. So
oh,
that's pretty bad. Yeah, people are furious.
Oh,
whoa,
is this
there it?
It
is.
We can't read that.
Simple as that.
That's everything that I said.
Look at that fucking garbage.
I nailed it. So Patrick pulled up the UK educational system.
We also don't call it we call it primary school.
You have common entrance examinations, GCSE examinations. They have a lot of exams. I guess we have like
you're just
text.
Narrowing it down.
Yeah.
So like you can pick your GCSEs, but you still have to do maths and all the crap that you hate.
Every year, everyone in Twitter is explaining it from the UK. They're all explaining it different. Someone literally said, sixth form is college courses, but it's not held at college. It's held at a school rather than a college campus.
Yeah, for example,
stop explaining the sixth form. Get your fucking shit straight.
Sixth form for me was in my own school that I was already at.
Okay.
I didn't have to go to a separate sixth form college.
I did.
Oh, you went to sixth form?
Yeah, I got 3 A levels.
What does that mean?
It is really just made
up. So do you have a college degree?
What does that mean? I don't know. I have qualifications.
You have qualifications?
Yeah.
So what if I ask you, like, we go all the way
like
from
the
first grade to 12th grade. We don't get anything all the way through to 12th grade. Once you finish 12th grade, you get a diploma.
That doesn't mean anything.
A high school diploma.
I'm really good for this job because of this one diploma.
I have a basic education.
Yeah.
No,
high school.
It doesn't tell what you're good at.
I'm not going to say the American, what we teach or the American educational system
is
superior.
That's what college
is for. I'm never going to say that.
No, we narrow down way earlier. Like, after you're like 14 or 15, you're like picking what you actually want to do.
That fucking sucks.
See, with
because what I wanted to do when I was 14 or 15 is not what I wanted to do.
Yeah, you don't know when you're that young. In my high school, you got to choose, like, you only had to do 3 years of math, 2 years of science, 1 year of history. And you could keep taking those courses in like the 11th and 12th grade, but you didn't have to. So there was a minimum curriculum that you had to take, and everything else you could fill with stuff you wanted to do. So it's like it narrowed it down, but we still have a understandable fucking school system.
Can you imagine how fucked you would have been if you had like chosen your career path at 13 or 14? Like, what would you be doing right now?
Oh, doctor. I'd be a doctor. I did. And then I went to university for pre-med.
Speaking of being a doctor, what happened to your finger there?
Oh, everyone's asking about that on Twitter, too. So you want me to explain that real quick?
Yeah.
How much? Where are we at? Okay.
Is it a long story?
So I
is
have
it longer than that conversation?
No, I'm just making sure that we don't have to do, like, business stuff. Like ad reads and whatnot. For those of you listening at home, I have a splint on my finger, which is, the splint is on a bandage. I did not break my finger. I'm not allowed to bend my finger. Trigger word.
gore and blood. is it a trigger word? Is that what you say? Trigger alert?
Trigger warning. Trigger warning. Are you gonna take it off?
What? No, I'm not gonna take it off. I'm just gonna tell a story that's gonna involve blood and horror and pain. I would not take it off because Gavin's freaked out by it. I'll show you. I'll get a picture right there on my phone that I took for Gavin. Though
you do what I do, where you like kind of curl up and you like hide your wrists and your neck.
I can't deal with like.
I got a new set of knives, and I'm very happy with my new set of knives. I like it a lot. And one of the cool things about having a new set of knives is that they cut through anything. Like cutting steak is like zip, barf and it goes right through.
I'm not gonna throw up. I'm just gonna get uncomfortable.
So Teddy likes this sub shop called Jimmy John's. But
I love Jimmy John's.
Yeah, but I try not to go there as much as I can, because even though Teddy loves it, because the guy, he's one of those guys that like goes and like kills like 1,000-year-old elephants and stuff. You know what I mean? And it's always pictures. Well, you got some right here in your face, there, Barb.
No, is it
other
cake?
Side, other side, yellow cake there. I got it. The anyway. That's political, though. We'll talk about that. So I bought bread from there so I could make him the sandwich. It's this day-old bread they have, which is just bread. Loves bread. So I bought that, and I was cutting, and I made a sandwich for him. Got everything. And then I noticed that when I cut the bread, my brand-new knife had, like, some smudges on it. So I thought, I'll clean the knife. So I got the knife wet, cleaned it, and then I was doing... I'll try to explain this so the audio listeners can understand it. I had a paper towel wrapped around it, and I was doing, like just cleaning it like this.
Masturbatory motions?
Like going outward from the handle to the blade, but also kind of moving the knife with it as well. And then went too far, and when it came back, I went zip across my hand.
Ew.
And I cut about 1.5 inches huge gash in my finger, just like instantaneously, like a scalpel. And blood everywhere. I ended up getting 6 stitches in my finger. And that was no fun. And then... Remember, I had made Teddy the sandwich, and I was cleaning up. This was
a blood sandwich?
This was after the meal. No, this is after the meal, and I was cleaning up and doing everything. So then after like 4 hours in the emergency room, everybody in the emergency room was really great.
Thanks, Nick.
The staff at Seton was amazing. I got home after all that, and I saw that on the kitchen table was Teddy's sandwich, and he had taken like 5 bites out of it. And I'm like,
that little shit.
And I'm like, hey, I go, your sandwich is there. I go, you didn't even eat your sandwich. He goes, yeah, I didn't like it. I was like, you fucking dick. I just cut my finger wide open for the sandwich. He's like, I don't even want it.
Probably lost his appetite watching.
Do you have a picture of it?
Oh, of what? Oh, you want to see?
Yeah.
No. Sure.
Wait, but what about the audience who don't want to see that?
I'm not going to put it up for the audience.
I'd like to see it. Pass it over here.
I'll figure out a way to post it where people who are disgusting want to see it.
I used to work at a Kroger, and I would unbox. I used to work in the dairy, and I'd unbox boxes of cheese. And one day, I was there with my box cutter.
So that is my big knuckle,
and I sliced
and then that's
across
my
the box, and I gashed my, open. My
that's my first knuckle, and my second knuckle. So it goes like all the way like this part. It goes. Zip.
Oh, you don't have a picture of the actual open gash.
No, I don't have that. Up.
Oh.
It's just the stitches. Gavin, it's just the stitches.
Ah!
Did you do it?
Gavin, when the knife hit my hand...
It's like a penis.
It was such a sharp knife.
This is the sandwich. Do you want to
I
see
could
the
feel like the individual skin layers like pop. Like it made like a domino feeling effect.
The sandwich looks good.
Yeah, look at the sandwich though. Do you not want to see it?
It's appetizing.
Well, the sandwich is just a sandwich though.
Everyone piss off.
Give me that phone back. The worst part about that photo too is, ow. Every time I extend my hand all the way, it hurts. I'm okay. The weird thing about that photo is it's that creepy live view that phones have now, where it's like a GIF kind of.
You took a live picture of your.
What is that? How do I turn that off? Can I turn that?
Yeah, if you go to the open your camera
phone.
And go to the top.
Yeah, and I do what now?
I'll show you how to do it. If you open the camera,
is that that little button?
Yeah, click that little.
Fuck you! Get off.
It's still open.
It saves the audio too.
Never mind.
What does that mean?
No, you're good.
I'm good.
If it's yellow, it's on. If it's not, it's off.
Picture my cake.
They're adding all that into the Mac now too.
So I'm actually going to be down in Australia. I have to get the stitches out 10 days after I did this, and I will be in Australia at that point in time for RTX Australia and some Laser Team stuff. So I'm going to have to find a way to get stitches out in Australia.
I think they have hospitals there.
I'm pretty sure they do.
You just bite them out, mate.
Yeah, but they have social health care, but I'm not a taxpayer in Australia. So what does that mean?
Just get health insurance.
If you get travel insurance. You should be okay if you get travel insurance.
I will just find a helpful person in Australia to punch me in the nose, and I'll go to the doctor, and then
I happen
to have.
Yeah.
Or think about it like this: if it's meant to be 10 days, 11 days probably fine too.
No, I don't think so. And I think 10 days puts me down there. I'm pretty solid in the middle of my trip.
No. Wait, you leave?
I go. Austin to Washington, to LAX to Sydney.
Why Washington?
I'll talk to you about that in a second.
All right.
Then Sydney. Then I'm in Sydney for a while. They got the premiere, got RTX Australia. Then there's another screening that I'm going to in Sydney on the 27th. Then I fly from there to Honolulu, Hawaii, where I will be attending the screening because the Honolulins, what is somebody from Honolulu called? Honolulins?
Hawaiians?
Honolulites. They got a screening in their place. So I'm going to go there and I'm going to watch the movie with them. And then I'm going to fly from there to LA, screen in LA, then from there to Austin. I had the dumbest fucking conversation, by the way. You have a story about Qantas. I want to talk about that.
I do.
As well.
Why is that pronounced Qantas?
I don't know.
There's no U, right?
Ashley tell me what it means. It means Queensland and...
What's an acronym?
Ashley, what does Qantas mean?
She's not there.
Oh, maybe if I yell loud enough, she'll be there.
Like a laptop on your lap. You're yelling.
Oh, yeah. Maybe I should look that up. I just wanted to reflect your knowledge and impress everybody. It stands, Qantas stands for something.
Queensland and something with a T, obviously.
Yeah.
Tasmania?
No. What does Qantas stand for?
I flew Qantas once.
Queensland and Northern Territory Aerial Services. That's what Qantas means. So it's an acronym they can fucking pronounce. An acronym however they want. That's why the GIF thing is like... You can pronounce it however you want to. It's a fucking acronym. And the person who made it up can actually say how it's pronounced. And I know people go like, well, why does it say GIF? Why does it say GIF if it's graphical for the G?
How is that different from any word? Like, what if I called you Borni?
let me give you another acronym. Because my name's not an acronym. My name is a set of words, letters
made
together.
Up. It's made up.
Yeah, but the word scuba, you don't say underwater. You say underwater. But you would never say scuba. That would be stupid. You say scuba, and yeah, it's pronounced incorrectly, but that's just what it's called.
I like underwater now.
Scuba.
Underwater.
Yeah.
Underwater.
With my duffel.
So I had to make a change. I had to fly. I was going to fly from Austin to LA, Sydney. Sydney back to LA, back to Austin. Okay. So I had all this stuff come up. I had to be in Washington on Wednesday, and which I'm glad Blaine's here because I'm going to clear something up on that as well.
Yeah, let's talk about
and
that.
And then I had to fly from Washington to LA to Sydney, now to Honolulu. So I said, okay, here's something. I'm going to make this really simple. I'm going to book all the other flights myself. I'm just going to change my original flight from Austin to LA to Sydney to LA to Austin. I'm going to change that to LA to Sydney, Sydney to Honolulu. That's
which
it. I'm going
less.
Less places. I'm going less places. Mm-hmm. I'm going less distance. I'm taking less flights. I called to make that change, and airline people are fucking crazy. And they have no problem just like saying insane stuff and acting like it's totally normal. I told the person I wanted to change my flight to LA to Sydney, Sydney to Honolulu. That's it. Nothing else. Really easy. I'm eliminating two cities. I'm eliminating two flights. What's it going to take? She goes, well, with the change fee and everything, that is going to be... altogether to change that $14,000. That's not a joke. She said 14, and she said it as calmly as a person could say anything.
Not 1,400.
That's what I said. I said, are you saying 1,400 or are you saying 14,000? She goes, no, it's 14,000. She goes, because we're doing a change, I can't get any discounted rate, so it's $14,000.
That smushes new tickets to all those places almost.
Might as well cancel class. Your flight and rebook at that point.
That's exactly what I ended up doing. I said I could book these flights right now online and just let my old ticket just expire and waste the money, and I would still come in at about like 60% less.
I don't get it.
Yeah, airline people are crazy. And they're like, that's a normal thing. Yeah. Airline prices are like gas prices. They make no fucking sense. The price of gas, of oil, has dropped from $100 a barrel. I sound like Joel now. $100 a barrel to $28 a barrel, yet at the same time, gas has dropped about 30%. You know, that's about it. Well, meanwhile, the price of oil has been absolutely gutted. And I know there's other stuff like... Someone explained on I was reading a discussion about this on Reddit. Somebody goes, well, there's other factors too. There's refining, which is definitely part of it. But refining to me is pretty static because the difference between the grades of gas have always been about 10 cents different. That's a refining difference. Like premium is 10 cents more than regular.
Right.
You know, and supreme is 10 cents more than that. But even though gas gets to be like $3 a gallon, $4 a gallon, it's still a 10 cents difference, and that's it. And the other thing they said was tax. But tax is related to the cost of the price of the thing. Tax would go down as the price of the thing goes down, too.
What about tip?
I don't know what it is. But yeah, so it's ridiculous. And also, I've also noticed in my life, I haven't noticed that days change year to year, but I have noticed that when the price of oil goes up, the gas prices immediately change for the positive. They go up as quickly as oil does as well. It happens, so they're looking into it. Okay, that's enough of my story. Where was I on the Qantas thing?
Can they just make all the oil?
Go ahead.
What do you want to know?
Like, are they still finding it? Why do you get oil? Just out of the ground?
Yeah, you just got out of the ground.
So why don't they just get it all out?
Well, some oil is harder to get than other oil. And that's, I think, been a big cause for the drop in the prices of oil, is we now have more efficient ways to get oil from different places, specifically in North America, like tar oil, shale oil. They have all new kind of developments in mining, fracking. You've heard for natural gas as well.
Yeah,
fracking is super efficient.
That's the stuff that makes your water flammable.
Yeah, well, that's, you know, somebody did that on the news. They lit their faucet on fire. That's pretty.
Have
fucking
you seen
freaky.
That thing you can do with ice? Where?
No, sure, go ahead.
Well,
I don't know how to answer that question. No. Yes.
Yeah, there's like a bunch of dudes walking on ice, and you can see like the water moving under the ice. There's a little bit of air. And they stuck an axe in the ice and lit it. And it like sucks all the air out of the underneath of the ice. And it's like a jet of fire coming out of ice.
That's really cool.
What is it?
I assume it's just oxygen burning. Or maybe it's like methane. I don't know.
That's got to be
something. Look up like ice hole fire video.
If I give you a glass of oxygen, you can't light it on fire.
Oxygen's flammable.
Gavin, I understand that. Do you understand what I'm saying? That if it's just oxygen under the ice, oxygen coming out through a hole does not make it flammable.
It does.
What are you talking about? You can't just light it. I mean, if it's pure oxygen, yes.
Yeah. It's
not going to be pure oxygen.
I bet it was pure oxygen.
Well, what if it was like making, maybe there's like a bunch of plants under the water.
Oh,
and releasing
so
oxygen.
It's pure oxygen, void of nitrogen, anything else.
Okay.
It's being trapped by the ice.
I think I'm saying air, and you're saying oxygen. You're literally saying it's pure oxygen. Sorry, yeah. Blaine, go ahead.
But
what are you going to say?
My contribution is null and void.
You guys hear about this huge methane leak that's in California? It's been going on forever.
Oh, it's been shitting methane into the air for...
It's like
worse than the Nissan. The what is that?
BP.
Yeah, the BP. Well, no, there was a worse one than
Nissan's
that.
Nissan's oil spill.
No, the Valdez something, blah, blah, blah.
The Exxon Valdez.
Exxon, not Nissan. Dumb.
I wonder, okay, Exxon Valdez, I'm trying to think, were you born when that happened?
What year was that?
Patrick?
what year was
Exxon Valdez? Patrick, play a game with me. Patrick's in our control room. Was Blaine alive when the Exxon Valdez crashed and leaked all the oil all over Alaska? Hey,
is he
shush.
Thinking?
He's getting coached.
Patrick's saying yes.
Yes?
I'm going to say he was not. When was Exxon?
I gotta really fart.
Valdez.
Do it. Fart.
So like, I had Chipotle for lunch today.
And what is Chipotle for those not living in the U.S.?
What about it?
What is it?
A lot of beans. Mexican food.
Yeah, when were you born?
1990.
March 24th, 1989. Bam. I'm one up on you, Patrick.
Oh. I also
you were not
wasn't
born when the Exxon Valdez hit.
But I know about it.
It's called a Nissan.
Barb, do you remember like what's the big news event? Because I discovered what it was in Gavin's life. What's the big news event like for kids? You know, my generation was the Challenger explosion.
Uh-huh.
What happened? I probably mispronounced something. So what was the big event in your life? The shuttle blew up. I said shtuh because it didn't do the full shuttle. It's just part of it, and then it exploded. By the way, if you made a Challenger joke in the late 80s, that was like way off limits.
Yeah.
Like way off limits.
So what was the big thing?
Yeah, what was the big thing? You remember?
I would think 9/11.
Yours is 9/11?
Yeah.
Gavin's is earlier than that, when Princess Diana died. That's like
the world.
I feel like I was still just a little too young when that happened, because that was what, 90?
But you don't like, it's like,
it was 97,
I always heard about like older generations talk about they knew where they were when Kennedy was shot. They could recall. Like I was in school, but I knew where I was when the Challenger exploded.
Yeah.
Do you remember where you were when Princess Diana died?
No. It was in 97, you said?
Something like that. I think I was like 9 or 10.
Yeah, so I was
11.
8.
I remember my mom like was like crying during the funeral. Like,
yeah, everyone in England was crying at the same time. It was really weird. I didn't know what was going on.
They're probably upset about sixth form trying to figure out the school systems.
I thought mine was like Oklahoma City bombing, because I was like a city away. In fact, my mom and I were there... I think like a day or two prior in that very building, and like where we were, I was at my babysitter's, and we could feel the shake from the Oklahoma City bombing.
So
are you serious?
I used to do business in the .com days, when internet stuff. I used to do business in Oklahoma a lot, and people who lived in Oklahoma, this is before 9/11,
it was always very telling to me because they could remember specific things in history or in their lives based on whether they happened before the bombing or after the bombing. Like, it was like this hard line in the sand for them. And now I guess for a lot of people, that's 9/11. Like, they can remember specifically things that happened. Well, that was before 9/11.
It's because it changed so much stuff about air travel.
Well, just everything.
Yeah. Terrorism.
Like, the way you view the world.
Yeah. Was Miss Mass's fifth grade class. My friend Tyler Keating came in and he told me that the Pentagon attacked. And I was like, well, they'll rebuild it and make the hexagon. It's a fucking idiot. Wow.
They'll make terrible.
He'll add another wool.
It is called the Pentagon for a reason. I could see them making a bigger one, calling it the hexagon.
I started drawing hexagons in class and like putting like missile turrets. Like, this will show them.
We know somebody who was in the Pentagon on the day that the plane hit. And the Pentagon is such a massive building. The plane hit the building and he had no idea.
Fuck.
Like, he didn't hear anything?
He saw it on the news. Yeah. It was David Ellis from
holy fuck.
Microsoft.
Wow.
Yeah, he was in the Pentagon on the day.
How big is he, like,
the government agent secretly?
No, I don't believe so. I know he worked in the prison system at one point. He had some really cool stories when he was a prison guard.
I watched a documentary last night about how some Secret Service dude shot JFK by accident.
What?
There's so many fucking
There's a documentary about that?
Yeah, it's on Netflix.
What was the rationale behind that? What was the main piece of evidence?
The trajectory of the difference in the bullet, like the bullet that Lee Harvey Oswald fired went through the president, through the other guy, like out the other guy and into his own leg. So it went through like a bunch of stuff. But the one that hit him in the head, like, exploded, shattered into pieces and like blew his head up. And they were saying that you couldn't have fired both of those from the same gun with that trajectory. And then they were saying that
a guy
on the car behind heard the first two shots, went to pick up the gun, fired it by accident and like blew the president's head off.
I don't know if it was by accident.
If you're telling me you could shoot someone by accident from one car to another, that is like, possible. Very, very unlikely.
And imagine that, the most freakish of accidents. You accidentally shot the president's head
from like what, 40 feet away,
while another guy is shooting at him simultaneously.
Yeah,
what a coincidence. That's too much coincidence.
Like, Oswald's like,
If you look at the Zapruder film, Zapruder?
Yep, Zapruder.
Yeah, there's a guy that tells dudes to back away before the firing happens.
Well, he like, CIA, say, like,
CIA guys are running up to it. And then CIA guys are running up.
He's driving their Nissans.
He's probably saying, like, get out of the street, the presidential limo is coming through.
No, but like, you look at the guys that are in the video and they're like, the fuck is going on? They're like, they're his armed guards and he's telling them to go away. And they're like, what?
The guy's name is George Hickey.
Inside job.
Look up that whole theory.
He's the bodyguard that actually shot him. So
I was watching that so dumb. Like, stabilized HD version of the JFK assassination. It's gruesome. I'm amazed at how close his wife's head was to his head when it blew up. Like, that must have been. She must have heard the bullet go through his head.
She was
like right there in his face checking out what was wrong with her. Damn it.
There is a photo of her when they're on Air Force One and LBJ's being sworn in, and she is just like 1,000-yard stare. For some reason they made her stand there. I guess some kind of continuity of government.
Like,
they felt it was a good idea for her to be like a witness.
Kicked in brain.
She's watching him be sworn in as president. That's the
How long VP. After her husband was shot?
Hours.
Shot? I don't know, but it was right after he was declared dead, I'm sure. You know,
My theory with that is, like, she wore the same outfit the entire day with all of his JFK's blood and stuff like that. And I think it was, like, from what I heard, it was, like, a symbol. It's like, look what has happened to your president. You know, like, I think she was there as, like, a symbolic thing.
So, you want to hear? So he was shot in Dallas, Texas.
Yes.
And there's a weird thing. Like, Matt has in his family a weird connection with major Texas history events. He has an aunt who was outside of the theater watching when they brought Oswald out of the theater when they went and found him to arrest him for the assassination of John F. Kennedy. And she was standing right there watching him go by. Theater. She was also on the mall at UT when Whitman opened fire.
Wow.
She was there at UT.
The guy who went up the tower?
The guy who went up the tower.
That was like 60-something.
Mm. Yeah, that was all in the 60s.
For both 60s. Of them.
Yeah, she was there for two major Texas history events. So really world events that took place in Texas.
So we should probably investigate Matt's aunt.
That's what I'm saying.
She might be able to tell you something about this crackpot theory. Did you read?
That's the picture.
Oh, God.
Yeah, I can't imagine.
That is not a happy plane.
That is, that is really gloomy. That's rightfully so.
Did you read that the filmmakers for Making a Murder that they are now like in total backpedal mode. Like that we've come 360 or 180 on those guys. I think it's two ladies.
Like
actually.
The filmmakers are now believing that.
No. They're saying they're defending themselves for leaving information. Like now, the level of scrutiny for the evidence they presented is now being used against them.
Oh wow!
And they're like, "Well, we left out that evidence because we didn't think it was relevant." It's like, "What do you mean you left out evidence that was relevant? Isn't this a whole documentary series about evidence being relevant left to a out, case? Yeah. Mm-hmm. And you know, people selectively choosing what they're going to include in the case and or not include?"
I mean, they're clearly spinning it one way, so they're going to leave something out. That,
but I mean, everybody. It's funny. Evidence. Everyone's reactions after seeing it were. Oh, I can't believe this. This guy, you know, what happened? And now everyone's flipping the other way, like overanalyzing the documentary.
Well, they just released also an interview with Jody, his girlfriend at the time.
Yes.
Saying she was like terrified.
She's totally changed her opinion of him and everything
yeah,
else.
Yeah, saying that she's convinced that he killed her.
Really?
Yeah.
Spoiler. I don't know what we're going to do about that show. I mean.
Whatever. Watch it. We've been talking about it for weeks.
It's been out for. I feel like I was really late to that ball game. And that's like, I started watching it like a month after everybody else.
Yeah.
And I watched The Jinx like 2 years later.
I need to watch both of those so that people can, you know, I can participate in the conversations. I feel bad.
Just leave now and start.
Okay.
Just kidding. Stay.
I've been out of town so long, so I can't do it.
So the long story short is, I hurt my finger in a cooking accident. That was bad.
And cooking JFK sandwich. Was job.
Sandwiches.
Cooking. yeah. I cooked a bowl of cereal.
So it's a bread knife.
Are you? Yeah, it's a bread knife, serrated one.
Oof.
Are you a good cook? Are you guys a good cook?
I see where this is going.
I cook a lot of ground beef.
This is a great segue.
You cook a lot of ground beef? Well, Blaine, you need to know how to cook. Not only do you feel like you know your way around a kitchen, but cooking at home means eating healthier and saving money instead of ordering expensive takeout again. But, Blaine, where do you start? Blue Apron has you covered. For less than $10 per meal, Blue Apron delivers all the fresh ingredients you need to create home-cooked meals. Just follow the easy step-by-step instructions. Each meal can be prepared in 40 minutes or less. No overwhelming trips to the grocery store. No more sad takeout. No matter your dietary preferences, Blue Apron makes it a breeze to discover and prepare dishes like creamy lemon linguine or shrimp and pineapple fried rice right in your own kitchen. Cook with ingredients that you've never used before, like watermelon radishes, farro, I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, and purple potatoes. And recipes are between 500 to 700 calories per portion. Delicious, and it's good for you. Right now, you can get your first two meals for free at blueapron.com/roosterteeth. That's blueapron.com/roosterteeth. Blue Apron, a better way to cook. And thank you, Blue Apron, for supporting our program.
We should order some food right now.
From Blue Apron? You think it'll get here in time?
No.
They don't want... You don't want to get sad takeout.
You're going
to
get some Amazon Prime now?
Oh, no. I keep forgetting about that.
Burgers.
One time we'll do it. You know what we're supposed to do? I wonder if we could do this. What if we got Blue Apron? What if we ordered that stuff and we did that steak cook-off that Gus and I can do?
Don't we have the Pancake Podcast coming up real soon?
Let's hope so. Let's hope so. We were supposed to do the Podcast Awards, and Gus never said anything about that.
I asked him about it a couple weeks ago, and he's like, we'll do it in January because it makes more sense now.
Well, now it's February.
Almost, yeah.
I mean, by the time we
get
back.
Yeah, he's not going to get back, but...
So we should cook our own pancakes.
We are.
Listen, I agree with you. Those people were very nice last year, but I was very sad that I did not get to cook the pancakes on the Shrove Tuesday podcast.
How long is that? Like a month away?
It's, I think, the first Monday in February?
Is it February or is it March?
February.
It's that early? I thought it had to do with Mardi Gras.
February 9th.
When's Mardi Gras? when's Mardi Gras?
So let me get this straight. This is a day ahead of where it was last year.
Shrove Tuesday.
Nice, Blaine.
It's not.
Shrove Tuesday.
Oh, was that a serious question? You asked what
Shrove
day was?
Monday last year. And now it moved up a year. Wait, this is leap year. Wait.
So if it's February 9th.
Oh, fuck. Dude, you guys fed me Chipotle twice today.
You fed yourself.
Oh, poor baby. Got two meals at work.
Wait, I ordered custom. Like, did you order beans?
Yeah. It's
That's
part of Chipotle.
Your food. Just take the beans out.
No, they're delicious.
Yeah. When you go somewhere to eat, how often do you change like what you order? Like,
never.
Tell me your Chipotle order.
Oh, it's a burrito bowl to go because I want the tin so I can shake everything up. I get brown rice, extra brown rice, please. Pinto beans, and then I'll have half barbacoa, half chicken, and then we'll move down and be like, okay, I want pico de gallo, two scoops of medium salsa. Come on, a little bit more medium salsa.
You're not ordering it right now.
And a little bit of lettuce.
I'm addicted.
A little bit more.
I don't know what it is, the Chipotle hot sauce. I love that stuff. Also,
it burns
their
my butthole.
Are like half chip, half salt. Those are the saltiest chips I've ever had
they're
in my life.
They're so good, though.
Yeah, they're really good.
They're so good.
Pico de gallo. That's a good one.
It's basically Rooster Teeth, right?
What is that?
Pico de gallo. So good.
It's like rooster's beak. Isn't it? Isn't that the translation?
Pico de gallo?
Yeah.
Isn't it? I don't know. Yes, rooster's beak.
Yeah?
Gracias, Patrick.
Patrick's the most informed person on the podcast.
I still remember the first time I came to Austin.
That's the Spanish name for our company.
And you asked me to get...
the Gaia Productions.
We had a barbecue one time when I visited Austin, like 5 or 6 years ago.
Yeah.
And I went to the grocery store with you, and you're like, hey, why don't you go down the aisle and get some vegetables and some pico de gallo? And you were like naming things, and I'm like, uh-huh. So is that like a cheese? I'd never heard that term before.
Yeah, I'd never
heard it. Didn't know anything. I think that might have been at RVBTO.
No, it was in Austin.
It was here?
Yeah.
RVBTO was the time we were making the jalapenos, and you and Brittany started cutting jalapenos, and she somehow got jalapenos all over her face.
She was rubbing her eye at the same time.
So crazy.
It's a bad idea.
Don't do that.
Don't do that. Yeah, and then she was crying, and she was like, then she started crying more because she said her tears were burning her face.
Yep.
So
that's so metal.
It was pretty impressive.
Yep.
How many times have you farted since the beginning of this podcast?
Oh, like I haven't announced all of them. I'm probably up to like 8 right now.
Really?
Gavin just
could we just not hear them?
Huh?
Are silent?
That's gotta
Gavin be. Looks legitimately upset with you.
It's gotta be a piece of.
What happened?
Was that?
Oh, you just
what?
Did one.
What are you talking about?
He looked me right in the eye and farted.
We had a moment, Gavin.
That wasn't a moment I want to remember.
Just think about when we watched The Matrix together. I'll be farting a lot more.
Have you ever farted on the podcast, Gavin? You've been on a lot of them.
Not really a big fart. To be
I'm looking at Twitter. If you guys want to tweet us at hashtag RTPodcast, I'll look at that now. Go ahead,
I would fart into the microphone, but I don't want to give
Gus I'm going to say this. I've been farted on more times than I've farted.
That's not true.
Yeah.
That can't be true.
Except for maybe when I was a baby and let out a few little
you
pops.
You don't fart like
Did
at least
giggle?
Once a day?
No.
Did you fart and giggle? It's funny. Probably. Farts are funny.
I feel like the majority of people fart at least once a day.
I had a weird thought the other day, thinking about this methane leak. It led me down the
like
same...
Farts?
Yeah, led me down the same thought process, is that I contribute more methane global warming personally to the atmosphere than my car does.
Your car.
Because my car contributes nothing.
Yeah, me
too. I was like, that's weird. Yeah, you too. Although you're getting a license. Gavin's getting a license.
No.
Really?
How many times have you said that?
Can we explain why?
I don't know. Did she say that?
No.
Oh, well, maybe not. I don't know. But yeah, I'll get one.
Well, she posted that she passed out.
Yeah.
So now that Meg has passed out, Gavin has to get a license because he has to be able to drive himself.
Wow.
Because she's worried about... you don't want to be behind a wheel and pass out. She'll be fine, though. She'll be fine.
I'll get one. It's about time.
It's
my 2013 New Year's resolution, so...
I was going to say...
I'll hop right on it.
We never did, like,
hey, 2014
of those.
Patrick, people want to see you on camera saying hi. Can you say hi on the camera?
On the broadcast?
Don't say hi to the camera. He just said hi to the back of the camera.
So we're going
to
cut
to
the... No,
that's bad lighting in there. That's bad lighting. Come out here, where it's better lighting. Come here.
Don't trust Blaine.
Patrick,
he's
come
here. Fart near you.
That's not true.
I think it's very true.
He might fart on you.
Oh, he's actually coming.
Patrick, come out and say hi.
We're not responsible.
You want to switch seats real
quick?
No, you're going over by Blaine.
It's Patrick.
He doesn't want to stay.
There he is. There's Patrick. He's the guy who talks in Gus's ear.
Patrick, how come you didn't want to sit?
He's my old mentor.
Because he's full of farts over there.
You'll ask me.
Old mentor.
You always ask me something that stumps me. Always.
You knew Pico de Gallo.
Because I was over there.
You're smart in there, but not out here.
I'm trying to think of an embarrassing question. No, Patrick, come back. I want to ask you an embarrassing question. Hold on. What do I remember?
He regrets everything.
Get out of there, Patrick. He's going to fart. I would get out of there.
I've smelled him.
He'd get out of there.
I can't. I got nothing.
Like, sorry. Bust an eye out. What if your eye just went...
Patrick was my first friend at Rooster Teeth.
Yeah. Hey.
Same here.
What?
Oh, yeah. You see that?
What about me?
You didn't shake my hand, so...
I gave you the fist bump.
Yeah, I was like...
Barbara never shakes a hand.
She came up and she was like,
RTX.
Hey, Blaine Train. And I was like, get the fuck out of here.
Well, that was your screen name. You dumbass.
That doesn't mean I go by it in real life. I'm not like, hey, Blondie.
No, you can't argue
Bernie
that.
Bernie did that for like the first 3 years I was here.
Yeah,
but I was
did.
Like 10. How old was I? No, I wasn't 10. I was like 16.
Well, I'm sorry.
You know,
it was around Gears of War.
I'm sorry for recommending you for the internship, which led you to get a job at Rooster Teeth.
Listen.
I'm so sorry.
I am so appreciative. I get you drinks a lot because I feel so, in your debt or whatever. You want a drink? Got some beer right there.
Thanks, Blaine. Wow.
It's for you. Got that for you.
Blaine Train. I'm going to call you that from now on because of that.
Nor do it.
So yeah, Qantas.
I had a thing today, since we're talking about screen names. I had a sad moment today because there was a birthday thread for me on Reddit. I thought, I'll go in there and I'll say hi to everybody. And I have a new screen name. And I went in there and said hi. I said, hey, this is Bernie. Hey, thanks, guys.
Really appreciate it. They all downvoted me because they didn't know it was me.
What's the new screen name?
It's my new screen name is Gus Cirola Verified. That's my new screen name.
Why'd you change it?
What?
Why'd you do it?
I just couldn't, because they, remember there was that thing where everybody had to change their passwords with Rooster Teeth? They, as a result, for security reasons, they changed all the passwords for all of our accounts. They changed the Rooster Teeth one, and I got kind of tired of asking Barbara and Gus what the Rooster Teeth password was for Reddit. And I don't really post anything ever. I go in there like maybe once a week.
The first time I ever made a thread, they deleted it and banned me, I think.
Because they thought you were a fake account.
Yeah, even though the account name was, ready for it, Gavin Free.
And they banned you from there? Are you still banned?
No, because I wrote a journal saying that it was me.
So my comment has 32 downvotes.
Damn.
Negative 32.
Is it
happy birthday,
and
then asshole.
I just wrote, let me see here.
To be fair, you didn't have any proof that was you.
I didn't. They even removed my other account, which was like, I just wrote, when you post on your own birthday and nobody recognizes your screen name, that's it. But they get rid of it.
The mods in there, they're very strict about rules. People pretending to be you, even if it's you pretending to be you.
Someone caught on that it could possibly be me. They wrote, people are not likely to believe text. You have verified in your username, but by whom and how? If you really are and want to prove it, I would suggest sending a message to the mods asking what they want for verification.
Ooh.
So
yeah, or not.
That actually sounds like Gus's real account, doesn't it? Like,
yeah.
That's Gus responding.
Or you could just say it on the podcast, and they'll all hear you.
Yeah, my name is Gus Roller Verified. I was like, thanks for the birthday, guys.
I also like how the picture for that thread is my picture because I tweeted happy birthday.
It's funny. It's very funny, isn't it? And then Chris's is Chris.
Yeah.
But mine, for some reason, is you. You get more clicks if it's you. So that's fine. It's fine.
Yeah, you know.
What was your Qantas story, Barbara?
I guess it's not that exciting. Not as exciting as $14,000 for a flight change. But
fucking A, dude.
So we're
she
going.
She said it so matter-of-factly.
We're going to Australia tomorrow, actually.
Brag about it.
Is when I fly out. And
I'm so excited.
I
love going
excited.
To Australia.
I couldn't be more excited. So about 2 weeks ago, I went in to make sure I could select my seats because I was like, I don't have shitty seats. I want to make sure I, you know, could spread out a little bit or have like an aisle seat.
Do you seat guru?
I do. Yeah. Seat guru, check which seats are good. So I selected my seats. It said confirmed. I'm like, great, got my seats. Went in today to make sure everything was good because it's 24 hours before the flight. And it said seats not selected. And I was like, that's weird. And then I went back in and I was like, oh shit, there's only like one row available now, so I guess I'll pick it there.
Maybe your plane changed.
And I clicked it again, and then I reloaded the page and it said seats not selected.
Uh-oh.
And I said, what the fuck is happening? And I'm flying with Aaron, so it's like I'm trying to get seats for both of us.
Yeah,
preferably to sit together. And I called Qantas and I was like, hey, I selected my seats about 2 weeks ago and they disappeared, and then I tried to select them today and it won't go through. And she goes, oh, yeah, well, your flight is through American, so you're going to have to go to the American Airlines website to select your seats. And I was like, there was no indication of this whatsoever on the Qantas website. It said it was confirmed 2 weeks ago. And now when I go to the American website, there's one middle seat available here.
That's
there's
a nightmare.
Another middle seat available there for $80 extra. There's a middle seat on the other side of the plane. There's no seats together.
My God.
That sucks.
So and everything is an upgrade.
Did it switch then?
I don't know what happened.
Through American for Qantas, operated by Qantas?
It was always
through Qantas.
It was a Qantas flight operated by American Airlines.
Qantas flight operated by American Airlines. Okay, that makes sense. So
mine is the same.
That's weird. That's usually the exact opposite.
Yeah,
it's an American flight operated by Qantas. So you're on an American plane, but you bought the ticket through Qantas.
Yeah. Well, I didn't buy it, but it was bought for me, yeah, through Qantas.
Okay.
This is why I let Chelsea ask and do my travel.
Yeah, I mean, she booked it for me.
Oh.
And
I get agita about booking travel because I feel like the moment I lock it in, that's when my plans are most likely to change. But if I wait to the last minute, then my hinge will never change, and then my ticket price just goes up.
Yeah.
I just don't understand how a seat on a plane that is empty and is going to fly through the air with the fucking seat empty, why is that the most expensive seat ever? Like, if you try to buy it the day before.
It should be the cheapest.
I get that they want to incent you to buy plane tickets earlier, but if like you buy it the day of or literally 24 hours in advance, then it should be like, we're fire sale on those seats.
Right.
Just get them sold so we can have a full flight.
But so I told her this. I was like, I'm traveling with someone that I'm going to be really upset if I'm not sitting next to this person. And she goes, oh, well, I'll make a note of it for the gate agent.
She's
that you guys want to sit together. And I'm like, what kind of shit is that?
Yeah.
Make a note of it. I'm going to go up to the front. hey, did you get the note?
I got a note. I got a note from the lady who sold me a ticket.
I like how polite and Canadian you are, and when you're mad, you're like super snarky.
You should have heard me on the phone. After I was done, Ashley Shoemaker in accounting, she was like, you go, Barb. Like, you okay in there? Because I was like almost yelling at the lady on the phone.
Oh, right, because you've moved offices.
Hey, yeah. Barb, what is the thing, I don't know how much involvement you have in Artichex Australia of doing it, but there's a deal where if you're going to Artichex Australia, you stop by the Doom Bar.
Yeah.
And then they're going to give away 50 t-shirts every day.
So there's this place in Australia. I don't know where it is. It's called the Doom Bar, D-O-O-M.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
they're like actually going to be showing the live stream of RTX Australia in the bar all day.
So you can go to the bar and watch the live stream and have a drink with your mates.
And yeah, the first 50 people, I think, that come in each day get t-shirts and anything else, or is it just t-shirt?
T-shirt. It's a Doom or UAC t-shirt. I don't know what a UAC is.
Probably some Australian.
Makes sense. I'm sure you guys down there. United Australian Council.
I was on a Qantas flight and I had to brush my teeth and I didn't want to get up to go to the bathroom to do it.
What's wrong with you?
You did not brush your teeth in your seat.
He did.
So I brushed my teeth in my seat.
You didn't do that on a fucking flight.
And I'm brushing my teeth, right? And I got my bottle of water and then I do this, swish around, and I spit it back in the water.
You're an animal.
And then I look at my bottle and it's like, it just looks like I came in this bottle. What do I do with this? And I wasn't going to give it to this, like, the lady that was going around.
Yeah,
because
you
trash.
Might look like an asshole if you had a milky bottle as opposed to like brushing your teeth and spitting at your seat.
So then like I like carried this like warm bottle of white cum looking stuff around and I like stuffed it in my bag because I was so embarrassed by it. I was like, how am I going to get rid of this bottle of cum?
It's just toothpaste and water.
There's nobody else on that flight unless it was another dude like you on that plane who would see you with that bottle and think, hey, that dude's got a big bottle of cum. There's literally nobody else on that flight.
I could have jerked off my seat. They give you blankets. It's so easy.
It's like 12 ounces. Yeah. How much was in the bottle?
I mean, how much do you sperm? You know, that's
12 like, ounces?
How much do you sperm?
Well, wait, hang on a sec.
Hey.
There was water in it, right?
Do you have to, like, switch condoms down the middle of
there was, like,
a
little bit of water left, and then I got it, and I used it to swish in my mouth, and I spit it back in. So, like,
well, how would you
it
come was, like, in the bottle if there's water in it?
But okay,
because the milkiness overcame the water. I used that water to.
You would have to aim. You have to bend your penis down.
Yeah.
Otherwise, you'd have to tip the bottle back, and all the water would spill out. Like, there's no situation.
You can come into a dry bottle. Is this a challenge? How much are you gonna pay
me? I'm saying there's no situation on a plane where there's water and cum in a bottle.
He's saying it looks like a 100% cum bottle.
Yeah. It's as if I just came into an
12
empty bottle.
Straight ounces. Okay. 12 straight ounces.
There was no like separation, like when you put oil and water in the same bottle.
There was a kid in my high school, and he used to wear like really baggy tracksuits and stuff like that. And the myth around school was that he would jerk off during class
under his baggy tracksuit.
Yeah, and you know, because you could see him doing this number, and he had his hand tucked away. And I remember one of my friends looked at him during class because he was just watching him, and the guy like just like. You know, doing whatever. And then he looked at my friend, and then he, like, pulled out his hand, and it was just covered.
Okay. Blaine cannot tell any more stories on the podcast. He's done telling stories. I'm not even sure that story was legal to tell. High school cum.
That was funny.
Good Lord.
He was 18.
Kid wasn't even in 6'4". All right, so the point of Blaine's story is go to the Doom Bar if you're in Australia.
Make sure you have your water bottles.
That would be great. Well, nobody else is thinking that, though. Nobody else is thinking that.
That might be the worst story I've ever heard.
Which one?
The last one.
Me coming in? Oh.
Just brushing your teeth while sitting down on a plane? It's the worst
story
I've ever
heard. The guy in the classroom.
No, the guy that would jerk off and then
like, have you ever done anything that bad with cum?
I've been told my gamer card is going to be taken away here. UAC stands for Union Aerospace Corporation. It's from the Doom video game.
Oh, that makes sense.
So that totally makes sense to me.
Gus would have known that.
What's that?
He's not, I said Gus would have known that. He's a huge Doom fan. Isn't he?
I'm a big Doom fan, too. I think all of us, like, there wasn't many video games to play back in the early days as there are now. I mean, like, I feel like there was only, like, 3 games a year.
And that isn't that why Jason got his username was from a big Doom game?
Well, everybody called him Poop. Because he came in as he had to type your own name on the network.
He made his name Poo Poo, and that became Poop.
And he became Poop. Everybody called Jason Poop for years. He was actually like, that was a time. Call him poop. I never call him poop when I see him.
There was
called
a time,
him poop for years.
There was a time where I knew you guys as, like, you kept your usernames
yeah.
a lot more in person than you do
You're
now.
Like,
now
Busby, right?
Busby.
But you used to be, like, called, like, G-Funk and, like, poop. They were, like, what you called each other around fans. For
Gus
a long
was
time.
The only person who used his name as his. Yeah.
But it was a small G
gamer
and
tag.
A big US, or what was it?
It was just a big S.
Big S at the end.
It was stupid. Right. Elite thing.
But everyone changed their usernames.
Yeah, we all went with real names after a while.
You still have your username.
I do.
From the very beginning, Gavino.
Never gonna change it.
Nope. All
right, so I'm being told that now the Upvote Brigade is helping me out on Reddit, so happy birthday to me.
Upvote Brigade.
So I'm sure I'll get banned for that, for like encouraging upvoting. Reddit, is, with their fucking rules, is so stupid. Like, you can't
I get
link,
Reddit
you can't like link to something that's on Reddit going, hey, look at this story about us on Reddit, so that people will inherently upvote it or whatever. You can't do that.
Why?
Because that's
can't
against the rules, and
that's
gaming the system. And I get it, because like by the time Dig went down, Dig was like half cracked articles, and there was something else. It was like, that's all it was. If a story got up on Cracked, it was on the front page of Dig, because it was just like everybody would like dig up those things, whatever the fuck you want to call it. So
I didn't realize Dig is still around.
Well, Dig's way better than it used to be.
I was number one on Dig the other day. I was like,
oh, were you?
Really?
So if, like, let's say one of our videos is on the front page of Reddit.
Go ahead.
And we're like, hey, that's cool. Like, look, our video's on the front page.
Yep.
The fact that we're linking to it is against the rules.
Yeah. And if you link it, like, if someone were to link it from a subreddit to that other Reddit, like, let's assume it was on videos, our videos.
Uh-huh.
If someone from the Rooster Teeth or Funhouse or Ruby subreddits, if they linked that video from the subreddit and people directed traffic from one subreddit to another, and then those people upvoted it in any capacity, they would all get shadow banned from that other forum.
Holy shit.
So if somebody linked a video on the Rishi subreddit to an R videos thing or an R image pics thing that got big.
I see people cross posting all the time though.
They could get so many people shadow banned from those major subreddits.
I know nothing about Reddit.
I don't even know what that means.
The only time that I was on Reddit was my cousin saw a status that I posted about Rooster Teeth, and he's a Rooster Teeth fan. And it was when we were like making iBlade, and I was like asking people to have like, hey, can you know, if you have any medieval armor, we're making a medieval themed thing. And he like posted, he's like, look at my cousin Blaine from Rooster Teeth posted. And I was like, you little shit. Like, that's my company, it's my job. And it was my personal Facebook page, yeah. Great story. Good job, Blaine.
don't put yourself
fart your way out of it.
It's a great story.
So how affected were you guys by Alan Rickman dying? Because he was, unfortunately, he's not even currently the latest celebrity to have died in 2016.
I was bummed.
Now, Glenn Frey from the Eagles is dead. Sorry if you didn't
shit.
Know that. Yeah.
Fuck.
Oh, yeah.
He was 67. Something about this generation, the late 60s.
He was 69? Yep.
He was 67. Wait, which one are we talking about? Glenn Frey now.
Glenn Frey.
He literally just died.
It's two great musicians and a really good actor.
Yeah.
Yep.
That's a bummer.
And
did you mention someone?
No,
from the Eagles
we're missing
recently?
Somebody else. You're missing somebody else.
Okay.
Huh? Two musicians and an actor.
Huh? Yeah.
No. He said there's been four people now who have died.
Oh, really?
Who's the fourth?
Two musicians and an actor, but there was another actor who died. It was Alan Rickman, David Bowie.
Yeah, I said two musicians. Bowie's a.
You think two musicians or three?
I said
Lemmy,
Bowie,
and okay.
Oh, Lemmy. I didn't even count. Yeah.
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 That's who you're missing. I knew the count was off. Sorry. And then Bowie is both a musician and an actor.
Yeah.
So when you think about Alan Rickman, what do you guys think of as the part?
Die Hard.
You think of Die Hard, really?
Fucking love Die Hard.
You think of Hans Gruber?
Yeah, he's the best villain ever.
He's tremendous.
Yeah.
Probably one of the best villains ever in cinema.
I think of Galaxy Quest, personally.
No shit.
Yeah.
Galaxy Quest is a great movie.
I love that movie.
You know, the whole time we were making Laser Team, there was
love
rumors.
Love Actually.
That Galaxy Quest 2 was going to production. I legitimately didn't want Galaxy Quest to come out 2 to come out the same year we had our thing. Because like whenever we talked about sci-fi comedy being a vastly underserved genre, you go back to basically Galaxy Quest.
Yep.
And that's the last like really great sci-fi comedy, at least that I can think of. I'm probably missing something. Pixels. You know, came out. You know, can I tell you something? I watched Pixels on a plane. I didn't mind it that much.
I heard it's okay.
I really didn't mind it that much. I did, however, see Adam Sandler's cowboy movie over the holidays.
Ridiculous
Six, is that what it is? That Mate. Was...
I thought that was
a
parody movie on Hateful Eight.
See, that's what somebody else said.
Yeah.
I think they're
Netflix has a lot of those like knockoff movies.
I think they're both plays off of the Magnificent Seven, which is a classic Western. Mm. I think that's where it comes from.
So what was the movie like?
And there's Fantastic Four.
It was tough.
Jeff said he liked it.
Did he? I will admit, we left it running in the background, and I watched like 5 minutes towards the end, and I really did find that part very, very funny. But like up until like, and I gave a good hour. I didn't abandon ship right away. Before that hour was up, there was like, we were all just like, I mean, my kids were like staring at the TV like, what is this shit? You know?
I mean, it had like, I mean, it's, so Adam Sandler, isn't he like making movies just to like pay his friends basically? It's always got like Rob Schneider and Kevin
but
James.
But all his friends have so much money.
I mean,
Kevin James had that King of Queens show. He was the lead on a sitcom for fucking 10 years.
Yeah.
That guy doesn't need any money. He's fine.
I think it's just a group of friends who do that. Like, it's the same with, what's his name from Knocked Up?
Oh,
Judd Apatow? Seth Rogen?
Seth Rogen and like all those guys.
If you have fun making movies and you can make movies with all your friends all the time, then why wouldn't you just keep doing that?
Yeah. Because everyone hates
you. It's kind of like Rooster
Teeth. Literally everyone hates your movies.
Yeah, but if you enjoy it, why not make them?
I don't know if they enjoy them, though.
Hey, let's do a screening of Jack
and
Jill.
You think they're miserable doing it?
I saw Jack and Jill.
Why?
Because it was a double feature at a drive-in, Galaxy Drive-In Theater in Ennis, Texas. And the other one was In Time, and I went there with my girlfriend at the time. And we just made out through that shitty movie.
So you didn't actually watch it?
No, because it was fucking garbage. We tried. And then there was like, oh, hey, it's Al Pacino not being graceful.
Have any of you seen this movie with Mike Myers called The Love Guru?
Oh no, that's fuck. One of the ones. Like,
with Heather Graham?
I think there was like two movies that like completely like stopped Mike Myers' career.
Well, she was in
Love Guru was one of them.
Spy Who Shagged Me.
Oh,
Austin Powers.
I was thinking of another guru, something.
It is. I've seen a lot of bad movies in my life. That was the worst movie I've ever seen.
Mike Myers. The one thing I like about Mike Myers not being, and I find Mike Myers to be very funny, but him not being a leading man is great because he shows up at like random parts as like supporting characters.
Yeah,
like he was in
Inglourious Bastards.
Inglourious Bastards. He was the was
fuck.
So fucking great.
Yeah, it was really good.
Dude, you want to blow your mind? Have you seen Ex Machina yet?
Oh yeah, hell yeah.
So you know that the guy who plays Poe is the guy in that movie.
Yeah, and then Hux.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, and then Hux as well. Hux as well. But I went and saw Star Wars again, by the way, I have to say. Star Wars second viewing, I enjoyed it much more. Not that I didn't enjoy it the first time I saw it, but I enjoyed it much more the second time.
I was the same way.
Because I was past all the referential stuff and watching it. I even liked I got okay with Kylo Ren a little bit more. But I still have to say that it's bad writing. It's not the actor, but it's bad writing that if this guy is like an evil villain on the caliber of someone who can destroy the galaxy or rule the galaxy, having a conversation about just come home and everything will be okay, it's like that kind of just like nerfs that character big time. You know what I mean? It's just That should be a lot weightier discussion.
I assume you guys have all seen the SNL skit with Kylo Ren.
Oh, yeah.
Undercover Boss.
Undercover Boss.
I like the
that
effects.
Barb, that made me go see it the second time, actually. That's really? Why I went and saw the movie, because I watched the sketch and then went and saw the movie again.
I like the effects in that sketch are better than the original Star Wars movie.
It's true.
Like the lightsaber.
It's very true.
Yeah, it was a very funny sketch, though. I like when he goes, have you seen Kylo Ren's lightsaber? Like, yeah, it looks stupid. He goes, looks great. I'm going to go see if I can find it. He goes, and he walks out, walks right back. Look, I found Kylo Ren's lightsaber.
I just like how it's like, when did you guys know? He's like, from Hi, I'm Matt.
Yeah, that was a really funny sketch. But, I'd like to see, like, some of those actors do more stuff. Like,
look right how there. Good that looks.
Yeah.
He kind of looks like, what's that? Movie with that guy,
Hot Rod, Andy Samberg.
No,
Napoleon Dynamite.
Napoleon Dynamite. Thank you.
Yeah.
Fuck. I was.
He's
not
an odd looking dude.
Yeah.
What's his name? The guy, Adam Driver.
Adam Driver. It sucks because I went to like of five of the six screenings that I've gone to, and I'm gonna see it twice more before it leaves theaters. People.
Do you
laughed.
Have tickets, or are you just making that declaration?
Making that declaration. Okay. I'll see it at least eight times.
People laughed?
People laughed when he took his helmet off.
Is it because
like,
he's a comedy character?
Listen.
Because he just looks like a fucking goofball.
He's like, I thought it was because he's
that's
in Girls.
It's like, to me, he's like, you know what it is? It's like when he takes off the helmet, and I think it's the most overanalyzed generation in history, but when he takes off the helmet, he looks exactly like the person I picture. Every time you read an article about millennials, that's exactly the dude I picture.
Whoa.
And he has the exact same attitude. It's like, he's like Darth Millennial is what he is to me. You know, when I see him there, and it is hard
Darth
to take
millennial?
That person seriously. And listen, it's going to sound like I'm making fun of millennials. I'm not. I'm amazed at how overanalyzed that generation is. I don't think I've seen a generation be so overanalyzed since basically the baby boomers, which I know is only two generations removed, but the baby boomers were like, it's when I'm growing up, it's all anybody could fucking talk about was the impact of the baby boomers and how.
What generation is the one above you?
Baby boomers are above me.
And you're a
Generation X.
And then there's Y after me, but I think Y then transformed into the millennials.
And then
point.
I'm a millennial.
No, I think we're Y. You and I.
But where's the cutoff? Where's the cutoff? Yeah, I'm a millennial. No, I'm a Y. Sorry, I got excited.
I thought millennials were the...
I mean...
Millennials are like the 2000s, I thought. Because of millennia.
Maybe we'll see. I'll look it up here. I'm looking up Generation Y for you guys right now.
I'm really guessing.
Millennials, also known as the Millennial Generation or Generation Y, are the demographic cohort following Generation X. There are no precise dates when the generation starts and ends. Most researchers and commentators use birth years ranging from the mid-1980s to the early 2000s.
So we're millennials.
You're millennials.
Fuck.
You guys are millennials. I am hardcore Gen X. I'm
so
solid
what's
Gen
above
X.
Us?
Gen Z.
After millennials?
Yeah, like my kids are Gen Z.
What's going to be after that?
I guess it's like they're going to go all the way around.
You're going to go back to A after that?
It'll be a capital A.
Well, they just named Generation Y as a response to X. The baby boomers were Generation W or anything like that.
Yeah.
So why was it X?
Because it sounds fucking cool.
That was like X everything at that point in time was like
X-Men.
When they named it X Games, you know.
It's
like
thing.
We were like the anonymous generation because we were so much smaller than the baby boomers. That was like, we grew up in the shadow of like Cold War and AIDS and all that stuff in the 80s. And so it was,
you know what I'm excited about?
Go ahead.
I'm excited about, we were talking about this before, how there's all these like first ladies of the United States. I'm excited about the first man.
Could be Bill Clinton. Bill Clinton as the first male, first lady. I don't know what to call him. The first
gentleman.
First gentleman. I mean, that would make sense, right?
The first gentleman.
Right. I assume that's the male equivalent of lady.
He'll probably call himself like, I'm Mr. Uno, or something. He'll come up with some goddamn name.
Who was the first lady?
I'm the first lady boy.
There was a, what?
Who was the first lady?
Probably Washington.
But what was her name?
Martha Washington, right? Martha?
Martha?
Yeah. Martha.
Martha, Martha, Martha.
Any other questions?
Nope.
You need to learn that in 20th form or whatever the fuck?
So would a gay president,
go ahead,
have a first gentleman? Would he be referred to as that, or would it just be
no?
Not
a gay guy would be way too smart to be attached when he's fucking president.
Boom.
A gay guy would be like, "Look, I can't be involved like on a long term basis. I'm gonna go alone on this one." He's the fucking president. That'd be fucking awesome. That would be really awesome. So no.
Are you allowed to be gay as a president?
Yeah.
What does that mean?
Why not?
Well, because like gay marriage wasn't legal until last year.
Well, gay marriage is like legal federally, so absolutely.
It'd probably be hard for a lot of people to vote.
Yeah, I'm
for
wondering
you.
If there's like some shady unwritten rule where you have
it's,
to be
it's horrible
president.
That you even asked that question.
I just think a lot of
but
Americans.
But it makes sense why you do.
It's abnormal to ask that question.
No, it's horrible that you would have to ask the question.
You have to, yeah.
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 I agree that it's a horrible thing to have to ask.
Can you imagine if there was a single president and he just gets so much action? That'd be the best.
It's amazing to me that there never has been a single president.
There'd be a reality show on like becoming the first lady.
Oh, it'd be like the Bachelor White House edition.
Yeah.
There's a
movie called
Do It Blaine.
American President with Michael Douglas and Annette Bening that's about that.
Do you think I'm too far gone?
I think they even made that character a widow.
Yeah. Over the cum hand?
Yeah. Too gone for what?
To become president. I'm 25, I got 10 years.
I think based off the history that surrounds you on the internet, you're too far.
No, you're fine. Everybody in your generation has the exact same problem you do.
I don't know about that.
Yeah, you actually, I think, have a benefit from a lot of other people in your generation because you met us after college, but you're in with a group of people who like understand the importance of an online presence, whereas a lot of other people don't have that influence in their life, and they just put fucking whatever online. I used to watch Barbara and Gavin in horror, like the stuff they would just like, they put anything and everything up.
You always include me in that, but I didn't do any of that.
You guys are fine. You guys are fine now, but you guys didn't see any problem with putting all the aspects of your life online. Like, I don't know, like pictures of you guys in your bedroom when you're like 15 and stuff, you know? Your posters on your wall and stuff like that, like all that stuff.
Oh yeah, I remember
that wasn't me posting pictures of the past.
Hello? What? When did we get involved with time travel in this?
No, I mean, are you saying that when I was a kid, I should have like covered up my walls? They were just the walls.
No, see, this is I love this kind of conversation because you can't even understand what I'm saying that you wouldn't post it. You're saying, I post for my room? Would I cover the thing? I'm saying, no, you wouldn't post that stuff.
Oh, so I shouldn't have put a picture of my face up.
Or you shouldn't like be posting from your bed. At that point in time, I didn't think you guys should be doing that. Now, give it a. I mean, everybody does that stuff. That's the least of your concerns. You guys are like,
wait,
you guys are tame.
Well, I remember
tame.
My parents were like, don't give your real name on the internet.
Yeah.
And now it's like everyone's name is out there.
What's your argument for not posting his pictures of his bedroom? Why?
It does, well, like...
Because they can identify where he lives?
Like it's little
things. Hey! There you go. There's Gabbo.
That was me.
Oh,
like
man,
me.
Nice posters, bro.
When I was a pretty girl.
Well, here's why. Here's why. Here's why. When Gavin is named creative director of Rooster Teeth.
Okay.
12 years later, 10 years later, 8 years later.
Congratulations. That happens. I never congratulated you.
What picture did they post? They posted that picture, right? They posted that picture. Being creative director of a company like Rooster Teeth, that's not a damaging photo in any way, you know? And I don't know what organization where that would be a damaging photo, but you can have stuff online that you just can't get back that you put out there. I mean,
we
all make dumb mistakes when we're younger. We all make we do stupid stuff. We're supposed to. I had the benefit of none of that shit being recorded. And you guys, not only was it recorded, you guys posted it yourselves. I mean, I'm glad there's no photos of me, like videos of you guys drunk at parties, stuff like that.
Doesn't exist.
I don't think that exists for you. Mm-hmm. You, I've seen video of you drunk.
Hey-o!
Yeah, stuff like that. And it's like,
well,
that's the kind of thing.
Most of it.
You're up there saying, well, I need to reform. We're trying to work on IP reform and copyright law. I'm trying to change it for the better of society. And like, and then they immediately cut to a photo of, you know, a video of you at a party going, I'm drunk and I love everybody. You know, it's just like, it's, you never know how that stuff can be used against you. It's the same thing with privacy, essentially. It's the same arguments with privacy. If you have nothing to hide, you don't have any problems until you have something to hide. And somebody's, you know, if they can cull everyone's information, they basically just wait for the people to rise in power and they use all that stuff against them.
So are you saying you're not only have the times changed, but you're more relaxed on that stuff now, right? Like, you've told stories that you probably wouldn't have 10 years ago.
That ship has sailed for me, though. This is it. I invested my life into this thing. That's what I did. Yeah. So, yeah, in essence, yes, I did that retroactively for a lot of my stuff. I really did. The thing about privacy, though, is that as you go forward in life and you build these things and you have this privacy, sure, we're all stockpiling, we put everything in the cloud, and it doesn't matter because we all do it, and no one's gonna really discover us. That becomes the exception, though, when you become a person of interest or a person of note. Yeah. Like, once somebody starts to run for governor, then they're looking for that person. Then they have all their stuff and all that other stuff. It's once they start to search for your name amongst all those other things, that's when problems arise.
Do you think that Sean Penn is going to get killed because he's associated with the El Chapo guy?
I have no idea. Why would he get killed for being associated with El Chapo?
Because they're relating El Chapo's capture back to his meeting with Sean Penn. They're able to track him. And that dude's, like, fucking powerful. Because now that he's, like, you know... I think, like, we're talking about, you know, link, you know, I don't know. It's just like he's connected to that guy now.
I think you've...
So, okay, listen.
Let's finish the thought here. I want to hear the end of this thought.
There's a mob boss, super powerful, probably has dudes on the inside of, like, U.S. government, like CIA, FBI, and all that stuff. And this guy goes, and he's one of the reasons that he is captured. Do you think he's going to get killed now?
Yeah. I could see him being in danger.
Yeah.
Possibly.
Yeah.
I don't know how that works, though.
I'm just saying, like, if you know, the way you represent yourself and like, who you associate yourself with.
I mean, I'm with you. I just don't see how that has anything to do with what we're talking about.
I do.
Oh, you know, Barbara does.
I get you. I got you, Blaine.
Yeah, I think Barbara's pretty careful with her identity online. You, though, you got some suspect stuff out there, Gabbo.
Like what?
Yeah, you do.
I don't know. Stuff. You drunk at parties? You know?
Where's Rooster Teeth?
What?
This is Rooster Teeth.
No, it's fine. I'm saying later in life, if you try to do something important.
Oh, I'm not going to try and do anything.
This is it. This is as far as you go. You could. The good solution is for some of that stuff is that instead of posting it on like social media sites, you could just post it all on your own website and then you can take it down if you want to, or at least have a little bit of control where people might not think to archive it, but you have it on your site and then you can just turn it off as needed.
I still see it as stuff of pride.
I'd like to remind everybody, this episode of the Rooster Teeth Podcast is brought to you by Squarespace. So if you're going to put your own website up, you can use Squarespace to do that. You can put all your photos up there, videos of yourself at parties, and then it's not controlled by Facebook or anybody else. That's what I would do. That's what I did. With Squarespace, sites look professionally designed regardless of your skill level. There's no coding required. They offer intuitive and easy-to-use tools to help you along the way. And you get a free domain name if you sign up for a year. Start your trial today at squarespace.com/roosterteeth. When you decide to sign up for Squarespace, make sure to use the offer code roosterteeth to get 10% off your first purchase. Squarespace. Build it beautiful. That is squarespace.com/roosterteeth. I want to thank Squarespace for supporting our podcast, even though Blaine said horrible things today.
He's great.
All right, what else should we cover before we go? Everybody got their phones, by the way, when I did the ad read. Everybody got out their phones.
I was looking at my stories to tell on the podcast.
Are we? We're not allowed to talk about the thing we're going to be involved in with
yet. Probably not.
Do you know if we're, me and Blaine are allowed to talk about?
What does that mean? What are you doing?
Oh, no, I wouldn't talk about that.
Okay. Yeah.
No.
It's going to be fun.
Sorry.
We are starting you guys are going to be the subject of a thing that we're doing. It's a new branch of the company. Yeah. That's kind of new. We did one for Let's Play.
Could we talk about your thing?
Live. What's my thing?
You know, your thing.
Oh, this week.
Yeah.
So the reason, Barbara, you were asking earlier, the reason why I had to change my flight and go from Austin to Washington as opposed to Austin all the way to Sydney is I have to go to Washington because on Wednesday I was invited to go to the White House.
Man, look at that. Are you serious?
Yes, I have been invited to go to the White House and to hear the president's plan for climate change and then communicate it to people like yourself.
Can you believe that? All the way to the White House.
I think they like to have a certain number of social media influencers. I hate the word.
Is it because you connect with the younger generation that might not be knowledgeable about this kind of stuff?
You got it. Okay. Yeah, that's the kind of thing. So it's like I think the administration is being smart about the way they reach out to everybody.
Well, I know that YouTubers have been to the White House before to interview
Obama.
They
just did a round of that.
Yeah, Hannah Hart's girlfriend, Ingrid, I think, went there.
Hannah Hart's girlfriend?
Ingrid.
I didn't know that Hannah Hart was dating Ingrid.
I assume they are.
I don't know.
I know that my friend Destin was doing it.
Destin did it?
From Smarter Every Day.
Swoozy?
I don't know what that is.
That's one of the guys. That was the first guy that interviewed him. He actually asked a really good question. He showed Obama the how would a dog wear pants? And Obama said that it would be on the two legs in the back. It would not be across all four legs. That's
smart.
Just silly.
Legit.
That's just silly.
So. That's a president right there.
How was that an argument?
I don't know.
Did you hear about this Nicole Arbor thing?
No.
You know
so
Nicole
Arbor,
right?
She was the one who, like, called everyone fat.
She did this video called Dear Fat People.
Oh, I remember that video, yeah.
Which, you know, caused a lot of anger, rightfully so.
I will say this, though. I will say this for her. She did not backpedal. She did not say, I was misinterpreted. I was taken out of context. She didn't do any of that stuff. She just said, it's a comedy video. I'm making fun of fat people. Okay, so go ahead.
Yeah. Well, there's this thing. She was dating a famous YouTuber named Matt something.
like we say, famous YouTuber, Matt some name.
I don't know who he is.
Big movie star, Tom. I don't know.
But they were dating for a while, and then they broke up. And a couple months later, I think, he released this video.
Oh, shit.
Crying, basically, cool. Saying, like, I need to.
You have my attention now.
It was basically stating that he was in an abusive relationship, like she was abusive towards him. It was domestic abuse.
That sucks.
And then she released this whole video saying that he's lying and he's just trying to bank off of her fame and all this stuff.
Wow.
And throwing her under the bus because they, you know, ended things badly because she broke up with him. And then there's this YouTuber that does these videos where it's two little animated stick figures with giant mouths just talking. And it's like a British voice. Do you know what I'm talking about?
Are we on the same story?
Maybe. But this guy did a video about how he found a video archived that she had deleted, and he happened to save this video of her crying after they had just broken up, saying that he broke up with her, she's sorry for everything she did to him, like basically backpedaling on all of the things she said in that other video where she said he was lying.
So,
but she had deleted it from the internet.
So, but she made it when they broke up,
yeah.
Apparently. So it's not like backpedaling, but more so that she was revealed to not be telling the truth.
Yeah.
Gotcha. Okay.
But it's just that whole theory of things are never, like once you put something on the internet, it's there forever.
She's obviously an idiot. I was surprised she didn't backpedal because that's like seems like everybody does now. Likewise, I was surprised that like people could remember to be outraged about something that happened 4 years ago.
Yeah.
You know, it's almost admirable because now it's like the culture of outrage is by the time the outrage reaches a fever pitch on something, they're already moving on to the next thing and discovering the next thing to be upset about. So that was
impressive.
Crazy. So that was a lot of fun to go through that. I had no idea. Totally got blindsided by that. It was nuts.
Yeah.
All right. What else do you want to talk about? Blaine, got any more stories from your Evernote?
Saw Gus in California and he ignored me.
What happened with that? I read that about that on Twitter.
I was out at Funhouse directing a shoot and I heard Gus's voice and I was really excited. And I was like, I ran in. And I think Will was there. And I was like, hey, Will, get these two off my set. Because he was with Bethany. I was like making a laugh. And he just was talking to somebody else. And he just totally blew me off. And I was like waiting for him to say hi. And I was like, he's not going to say hi to me. And I walked off and he never said bye.
Oh, God.
It really hurt my feelings.
Wow.
That was probably his worst nightmare.
Gus will shut you down.
I mean, he was at the Funhouse office.
Yeah.
So it's not like he was in public somewhere, not expecting to see anybody.
Yeah, that is kind of mean.
It hurt. Now Gus is going to get a lot of tweets about it. I feel bad for Gus kind of now. But
no, do it. Make him feel bad.
Yeah.
Make him suffer.
So is Gus already in Australia?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or he left yesterday.
God, he's going to be desolate here.
going to be lonely.
Are you going to be sad?
Oh, man, yeah. It's going to be a bummer for whoever has to stay here. Woo.
Yeah, yikes. But you're staying, huh?
Yeah.
But you're going to Pack South, aren't you?
Yeah, I'll go to Pack South.
That's cool.
I think it would be, am I allowed to say who's going?
Yeah.
Yeah?
I don't see why not.
It'll be me and Jordan Swears representing the Rooster Teeth. And then there's going to be two guys from ScrewTech and two guys from Funhouse. I can't remember.
I think Joel Rubin is one of them.
Okay.
And someone else. I forget who.
Yeah. So
be a good group.
Yeah, it'll be a fun panel.
You, me, Chris, and Jack went to Pack South last year.
Yeah. Jeez, that was a...
Was it not good?
No, it was good. It was just... Well, so I noticed that they're switching up the...
You could say it was shitty. They're a competitor now, so...
It was crap.
I just remember that we were there from like start of, you know, opening of the floor to like the end of it. And we had like a lunch break.
Yeah.
But they actually have it broken up to where our signing times are all different.
Mm.
So I'm going to be able to actually like explore, you know.
I like everyone complains about that now. Like I was there the whole time at the booth.
But
That's what we always used to do. Like everyone who went would just be there the entire time for the entire convention.
I don't want to leave when it's
a normal convention.
No, I mean, it's fun and I'm not complaining about it.
And then you'd also have to sell.
Yeah.
you got to be on your game and stuff like that. Because like the way that you represent yourself, you know, say you're like tired for one person, they're going to walk away from that feeling like, wow.
I have three days of game.
Yeah?
I can go 3 days in a row and then after that, I'm like,
ooh. So like PAX Prime, that's 4 days. It's like, oh God. Or Comic-Con.
Oh,
yeah. I don't go to Comic-Con for that reason.
San Diego Comic-Con is brutal because it's pretty much 5 days.
Yeah.
Because Wednesday, I think, is a press day and then starts on Thursday. And so you're there 5 days at the busiest convention, I think, in the U.S.
But I'm excited to go to San Antonio. It's going to be a lot of fun. It's a lovely city. And I only had to drive there and not have to fly. So I'm flying fucking everywhere here lately.
So when do you leave for Australia, Barbara?
I leave tomorrow. On my random seat.
Oh, yeah.
Wherever I'm going to be sitting.
You're going to hate every second of that.
You're on the same flight as me, I think.
No.
Well, he's going to...
I'm going to Washington now. You're on the same flight as Ashley. In fact, if you want to, there's a seat right next to Ashley that will not be used.
Good to know.
Hey. And she's... Oh, Barb's on your flight, Ash.
But they'll give it away.
Hey, Ashley,
if you don't check
but
in...
But if she knows the seat will be there, I can cancel it, and then she can swoop in and snag it.
Ashley, you probably missed this part of the podcast. Just don't brush your teeth and then spit into a bottle of water, because it's... Oof.
I just lost my
She's
notes.
So confused right now. I can't see her face.
So,
I don't think they'll think that she came in a bowl.
Oh.
She's just there. Like,
yeah, that's true.
She's going around taking collections.
DJing.
Hold on one second. Where's my stupid thing? There was a thing I saw that would be perfect for us. We should use when we're all back together again after Australia. There's a hotline that's been established that film companies can call for scientifically accurate information. Like if they're presenting something on screen that's scientific, they can call to make sure they're getting it correct so that they have scientific accuracies in films.
Was it like Bill Nye's phone number?
So we should just get that for us.
Is it exclusive for just film production companies?
Or? No, I don't know.
Call it.
Oh, I was going to call it today, but I didn't have time. And for some reason, my note is not syncing. Oh, here it is. Oh, this happens. This is one last thing I want to close on. So is there anything less depressing or like sad, just like pathetic,
less or more
online in social media than like when you see somebody who like follows you on Twitter and it notifies you and it's like, oh, so and so followed you. Like, wow, so and so followed me. That's really cool. I feel like that's a huge honor. And then you look at their thing and they follow like 800,000 people. What is that? And it's like the biggest letdown ever. Just like, I don't know what that is. It's like, oh, this person also follows.
There are some accounts on Twitter that are verified. It doesn't say what they do. And they follow the same amount of people that follow them. And they're just like these sort of fake Twitter famous people who I can't figure out what they do. And there's like several that follow
them. It bothers me when someone's verified or they have a lot of followers and they just have a username and that's it. They're like no link to a website or a YouTube channel.
Because you don't know who they are?
And, or it's like they have like a
pseudonym. They're that confident. They don't need to tell you who they are.
They're verified as an egg. It's an egg that makes tweets all the time. Yeah, they verified it. They found them in the grocery store.
Like, how does that work?
It's like a Twitter account. Yeah, I found that funny because I was like,
you came first.
I had that moment on behalf of somebody else where they were like, oh my God, I'm so excited. So-and-so followed me. And I'm like, oh wow, that's really cool. And I was like, for some reason, I wanted to see that they were following the person. Like, I want to like see the list of people they follow and they also follow this person. It's like, oh, they follow like, I think it was like 190,000 people.
Who was it?
Who was it?
I'm going to rat anybody out.
Have you had that
who was the celebrity?
Yeah.
I don't remember now.
Tom Offit.
I honestly don't remember the celebrity.
I was there for that, wasn't I?
I can go look it up.
Today?
You might. No, it wasn't today.
No,
it was a hospital trip and a few days ago. It was a while ago. But I remember the person who it was, so I can very easily find it again.
Hmm.
And we'll do that. We'll do that afterwards. we'll wait. In fact, a lot of times when I tell stories like that, I purposefully will put a lot of time between the actual event and when I talk about it on the podcast, simply because I don't want people to piece together that I'm talking about them. Or people to go through, like people that I follow, find that person, go, Bernie really roasted you on the podcast. Because people will do that all the fucking time. I can't stand that. There's a weird thing on Twitter when people tattletale on you.
Yeah.
Like, they like, it's the lamest thing ever. Like, you're talking about, like, something like, oh, hey, Bernie is talking on the podcast about how much he hates at Taco Bell. What do you think about that at Taco Bell? It's like, get a fucking life. Yeah. Go do something else. I mean, it's like, and then you won't be Taco Bell. Use Taco Bell because it's an easy example. They'll name a person or whatever, you know, and they'll do that. It's just like, how fucking bored are you doing shit like that?
Someone we kept asking who I was talking to, and people were going through my Twitter and talking to every girl that I followed. Like, I have a lot of female friends that I follow on Twitter, and they would tag them and they'd be like, hey, you two dating? And it's like, stop. It's not, it's weird.
That's a little too far.
Yeah. But have you ever had that moment where you were following somebody and they were following you and then you realized that they unfollowed you?
Oh, all the time.
Yeah.
All the time.
Joel and I are constantly following and unfollowing each other.
Joel Heyman?
For whatever reason, yeah.
Yeah.
Have you ever told Joel to follow me?
Yeah. I think we had a really awkward moment in Australia once where we're like,
did you confront him?
No. I would never. I don't care. But I figured, like, we figured out the only way we can communicate with each other was through Twitter messaging. And then we, like, got onto each other and, like, all right, well, I guess we should message each other. And then we realized neither of us were following each other. And we're like, here we go. And then, like, after the trip was done, we just both stopped. He unfollowed me and I unfollowed him.
The worst thing. I'm not sure if I already mentioned this. My memory's bad at the moment. But
why?
Girls keep getting matched on Tinder with people using my photo.
Dude, I see people on Twitter all the time that use your photo or Michael's photo a lot. And it's like, it makes me do a double take.
On Tinder?
No, Twitter. Oh. Twitter. I'm not on Tinder.
Oh. I was going to say. But yeah, the people keep saying, like, this, I got matched with it. This is not you, right? I was like, no. But the one guy was like, yeah, you know, I'm this old. I like this kind of stuff. People sometimes tease me about my nose, but, you know, I like it. And it's like, he's using my picture and also, like, talking about my own face as though it's his face.
Your own insecurities.
Yeah. Use your own face, you bastard. You were born with one.
Also, like, what's going to happen? Like, let's say he matches with someone, has a good conversation, just like, let's meet up in person.
Yeah.
So,
all of these girls.
You guys have all been online dating profiles? Mm-hmm. Any of you guys ever been catfished?
I was going to say, so remember when I went on that whole Twitter, I'm taking you guys out on a date thing?
Yes.
That was a catfish. I never said that because I was, like, really uncomfortable about the whole subject. So a lot of people were asking, who is this person that ditched you on your date?
Let's take a step back.
What's up?
One day, Blaine went out on a date.
Yes.
And he got stood up. And so he did this really funny thing was he said, hey, Twitter, my date stood me up. So I'm going to take my blade. I'm going to call your dates blades from now on. But he said, my date stood me up. So I'm going to take all of you on a date. So, and he did, like, 8 posts, 10 posts. And it was one of many things that Blaine has done that have gone completely viral, like when he proposed to the princesses at Disney World and stuff like that.
Then the Star Wars prank.
And then the Star Wars prank, too. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so this was one of the things that Blaine did that just went nuts. Like, it was on everywhere, Huffington Post and everywhere else. Anyway, go ahead.
Yeah, so that person, I was getting tweets, and they were like, who is this person that would stand you up? And I was like, you know, I'm kind of curious. So you can do reverse image searching. So I did that and ended up being a model from California with a completely different name.
Oh.
And I texted the person that who, you know, I had this date with, and I said, you took these photos from somebody in LA. I don't know why you would do that. Just, you shouldn't do that to people. And then I just stopped talking
to
them.
Did they not respond?
No. But like,
Do you think it was a fan?
I've interacted with a lot of, like, I found people on Twitter, and then I'll get screenshots of people being like, I found Blaine on Twitter or Tinder.
Yeah,
so and it's
weird.
Like, please don't.
Like, the only reason I know that people are using my stuff is because girls that I actually know are getting matched with me.
Oh, like from England?
Well, like, yeah, like people from my past, and it's like, it's just so weird. Like, what are the chances that they get matched with that person and also know me personally? Such a weird chance.
Do they make the name your name too?
No, just the picture and the description. Oh.
There's like, I've gotten to the point where I can sniff out a catfish in probably like 3 or 4 sentences, or like just based off of their profile and just like the way that their pictures are, their bio, like, it's like, that's clearly not a real person.
There are some very talented people who make sketches from the podcast conversations every week, and I'm just hoping that somebody has Blaine sniffing out a catfish.
Oh, that's funny to me. You sound really depressed by this. Is this like the biggest pitfall in your life is avoiding catfish and like...
It makes dating hard. Like,
well, you
really
could
hard.
Just date though, really, couldn't you?
Yes.
And not use the app.
I'm a very busy person.
I'm so sorry that fucking generational dating for you is so difficult. Like for your generation of like swiping and clicking a button on whatever you like and then just showing up at your door. I'm so sorry that it has like a monkey wrench has been thrown in that process for you.
Yeah.
I'm lucky enough to never have to have done that. It sounds awful.
Yeah, it's fun.
I think the internet was kind of coming around when you were. You couldn't date anybody that you couldn't meet in person, like for the first time. You know what I mean? Or somebody could set you up with somebody you knew. The idea that I could find somebody in another state to date is like impossible. I'd have to go to prison and start writing housewives. That'd be like the only way to do that. I mean, seriously, it's like you guys are just used to like, you know, oh, I met somebody who lives in Canada. Was that I met Ashley when she lived in Australia.
Yeah. There must have been some sort of retro VHS version of Tinder, though.
There was. There was like Love Connection, which, by the way, Joel
Press
was on.
Pause.
Really?
The show Love
oh,
Connection.
Oh, yeah.
Joel was on Love Connection.
There was a serial killer on that show, too.
That's
completely unrelated.
That's just a numbers game. That's a numbers game.
Just like the UK school system.
Yeah, exactly. So, I can't believe I just said that. I hope that's okay that I said that Joel was on Love Connection.
What?
Nobody's going to be able to find that episode.
Now he's going to want to follow you.
Too late. Boo-hoo.
Now it's his career.
It happens. Yeah.
Oh, was that the end of the story?
What story was on?
I feel like I was listening to you, and now you're on your phone. I was saying
I'm sorry. Sorry, it's upset. He was telling a story.
Oh,
and interrupted him.
I was looking the wrong way.
Oh no, it's just weird. Yeah, it makes online dating hard, and I could go out and date normally if I wanted to.
Why don't you reverse it? Like, have your picture as some like mega ugly guy, and then when you show up, you're like, hey, surprise, surprise.
You're welcome. But then what if she's like, I was into that?
She'll never match with me to begin with. So there's the speed bump. Cool. Some dickhead named Michael keeps using my pictures and acting as me, but with a different name.
A lot of people have found my pictures on like so OkCupid. And like weird. Those types of dating sites.
Meg has a funny story. Sorry, I patted your knee. She says that she used to be on like online dating sites like way back when, and she would constantly get reported because people are like, "Hey, you're using Meg Turney's," and she's like, "No, it's really me." Yeah.
It's like my problem with Reddit, but for
who do you think is the most used person for that
in the company?
No, of anyone we know, who do you would be like their photo would be used like?
I'd say Barbara or Meg. It's gotta be a girl. Yeah. And well, then like in terms of like guys,
it has to be someone that's one of like you or me. Well known for being attractive, but not well known enough that the majority of people on a dating site would recognize them.
Yeah, we had a thing where Gavin and I were somewhere recently. I'm trying to think. See, this is pretty recent. So we were. I'm not gonna say where we were. We were somewhere recently, and we ran into a model of note. I will say that. And she found out we were YouTube people or like online people. And she got really excited about that. And she goes, I'll follow you on Twitter and you follow me. Do you remember this person now? And I was like, oh, okay. And then like Gavin and I followed her. And she goes, oh, I don't have my phone. And then she I stuck with it maybe like a week to see if she would follow back. Like she said, I'll write all your stuff down and I'll follow you guys later.
Bullshit.
And I was like, this is really interesting. And so then I noticed I went and unfollowed her. And I went and looked at your follower list and you had unfollowed her as well.
I never followed her to begin with.
You never followed her in the first place?
She was like, follow me. I was like, yeah.
So I thought that was a really weird exchange because that was like a really like tense thing. It was almost like Gus's Yelp thing where she was watching like... Making sure that we follow her. It's like a lot of work to get one follower.
I'm not really at the point in my life where I'm like following models that I meet. I don't need to do that.
Just porn stars.
I've never met a porn star. But we worked.
You
follow
with
them, don't you?
Yeah, I mean, I follow a stranger. Yeah, why not?
But you also follow people you work with, right? We worked with her. That was the connection.
Once.
What?
Once.
Yeah, right. Once.
I don't believe in political follows. I think I have like 76 people that I'm following, and they're all like friends, just like people that I interact with.
You follow 76 people.
Mm-hmm. Gavin actually follows way more than I do.
You have like
I follow 1,000 people.
Yeah, I couldn't do that because that's not Twitter. Like,
oh, I mean,
I
don't look at the timeline.
See, but
I don't use Twitter.
So what's the point of following anybody?
So matter of factly, I follow them, but I don't pay attention to them.
I read mentions.
So basically, the only way you would have seen something that, like, let's say Bernie and I or Blaine would tweet is if we mention you. That's the only way you would see something that me or Bernie tweeted.
Yeah.
Is that weird? I only follow people who talk about me. I love it. I love that approach.
Wait. You never look at your timeline.
I looked at it about a month ago. Like, glanced it. I'm not going to scroll down through that thing. It's ridiculous.
It always makes me feel special when Gavin responds to something that I put on Twitter because I assumed that that was the case.
A lot of the time it's like...
You're not happy when you see something from me? You get a warm, fuzzy feeling from
me?
No,
I get really good warm fuzzies.
Yeah,
anytime,
cover.
Anytime I'm friends with someone on Facebook and they have Twitter post to Facebook, I see a lot that way.
Uh-huh. I don't do that.
You don't?
We're Facebook friends.
We're not friends on Facebook?
We are. But it happened just a couple months ago. And I think I was in your friends request queue for ages. And I was like, it was like, you are now following Gavin Free, but you are not sending a friend request because he has too many friend requests. And I was like, fuck this. I'm not following Gavin because of that. I was like, I'm not going to let him get this one up on me. And then you added me.
Facebook did a thing where it maxed out the amount of requests and then it broke the page. I can't load the page to deny everyone.
Too many people want to be my friend.
It's just not designed for that many requests, I don't think.
I screwed up twice on social media things. I had what's the clout? Is that the account?
Yeah.
I did the dumbest thing ever. I had my level on clout, and then I saw cheeky people who, watch our shows. They went and gave me plus ones in silly stuff, like sandwiches and tacos and,
Well, they're not wrong.
I know, exactly.
Can you explain this? It was,
all this funny stuff.
Can you explain this to a caveman?
Wet dreams on airplanes, a lot of stuff. No, I can never explain this. Clout. So I thought, I'm going to clean up my clout profile. So I just got rid of all these cheeky plus ones. I lowered my clout score by 10. And I was after doing that, I didn't know that was a side effect of doing it. I was oh. And then I just got rid of my account. I absolutely deleted my account.
What is clout? I've never gotten anything
through. They would send you stuff. So I don't know. I'm done with social media stuff.
Here's how clout works for me. I have this clout level, and then they'll be like, you got new perks available. They'll email me that.
That's it.
And I'll click it, and it'll be like, they've run out. But thanks.
That is exactly how that site works. But doesn't Meg get stuff from clout all the time?
I don't know how. She gets stuff from everyone.
Yeah. Becca gets stuff, too. Becca Fraser gets stuff from clout all the time.
It's because she's mentioned it on her Twitch.
She's just really good at social media, and I'm
rubbish. Does Jack get anything? Because Jack's always pushing for free stuff.
A lot of people.
I will take free stuff.
Jack got a turntable, I think, for free.
I have an inexplicable thing that keeps happening.
Do you like free stuff?
I love free stuff. But no, is it?
I love free stuff.
Oh shit! Who is it? General Mills?
Yeah.
Keeps sending me badass cereal.
Yeah, they send you the Star Wars cereal with lightsaber spoons.
I think I have a connection, or maybe it's just because they recognize me as a really big Star Wars person. And then now I'm on some sort of list. But they sent me Star Wars cereal, and then they sent me Batman versus Superman cereal.
Yeah, maybe you dated them on Tinder.
Jersey Mike's is going to send us a gift basket.
Maybe.
What's going to be in that? Subs?
I don't know. But apparently it's coming this week.
Why would you sound so angry about it?
What happened?
I don't know. What's it? Because Jersey Mike's to the podcast, you mean?
Yeah. I don't know if they've
heard us. They're not going to send a bag of knives. Don't worry about it.
Stitch remembers.
They heard us talking shit about Jimmy John's.
Should we wrap it up and go to the post show?
Wow. Barbara wants to fucking kill the podcast. Okay, let's do that.
I have packing to do. I have traveling to do.
Anything else we should cover? Anything else?
Laser Team.
Laser Team is coming out.
There's some deadlines to confirm some screenings by 11:30 tonight, I know.
Well, that's on the Monday version of the podcast. So, to be clear, if you're listening to this podcast on Monday and you're seeing it live, tonight is the last night in which you can buy a TUG screening ticket to verify a screening. In other words, make it happen. Tickets will still continue to sell after that. So if you're listening to this podcast on Wednesday, you should still be able to buy tickets to screenings for TUG that have been confirmed and have not yet sold out. They'll continue to sell those tickets right up until the screening starts. And then there will also be the opportunity to buy tickets for the normal, quote-unquote normal, theatrical run of Laser Team, which is coming very soon.
I think the deadline of tonight is only for the 27th and 28th screenings, though, if I'm correct.
And I also, I heard that there's certain people that are making surprise appearances in certain places.
We are. There's people going different places. So.
Have we talked about Fiji?
No, you want to talk about Fiji? You wanted to end the podcast.
No, it has to do with Laser Team. They managed to get a screening in Fiji while we're going to be there on a vacation.
You guys are going to go on vacation after RTX Australia.
Yeah.
You guys are going to go to Fiji. It's a big group of you guys.
Yeah, seven of us.
Seven of you guys.
Seven people going to Fiji?
Yeah, we got
an Airbnb. Is one less person going now?
No, we were six originally, now it's seven.
Ah, okay.
Who's going?
Myself, Aaron, Chris, Bethany, Adam Kovic, Jess, Bruce.
Aaron Marquis.
Yeah.
Do we not differentiate between Aaron Marquis and Aaron Zech anymore? Zech? How do you say your last name?
She ain't around though.
Usually when I talk about Aaron, it's male Aaron.
Gotcha. Okay.
Since he's my boyfriend.
Can you bring me back a souvenir?
I lost the list.
I will. I'll bring you back a postcard.
She'll bring you back a bottle of cum.
Yay!
Quan Quantas. So while you guys are there,
the other way.
Doreen and Matt made sure to get a screening so you guys can go to see a screening of Laser Team in Fiji.
Bye, Jai.
So you'll be on the clock.
What language is Fiji?
What's that?
I think that's the English pronunciation.
It's Fijian.
It's Polynesian.
They speak English?
Polynesian. Yes.
They speak Polynesian?
Mm-hmm. They speak multiple Nesian languages. That's what that is. That's what it is.
I don't know still, though.
Head, nose, and Tijian.
I don't know what the native language
is. I'm pretty sure it's English.
Okay.
Or a Fiji.
I mean, I don't know. Because it's like we're going to a touristy area, so they speak
French.
English there.
I wonder what their school system's like in Fiji.
No, stop it. You're getting all the way back to the front of this. What is native language in Fiji?
Fart poop dude. Did I mess up Siri?
No.
I'm typing. Now I just said fart poop dude. I do that to my dad all the time. Fucking pissed.
All right, are you ready for this? This is a great note to end the podcast on. The official language of Fiji.
Maltonesian?
Is Fijian. Good night, everybody.
No! I love you.